Mayutani's the goat. What's up, dude? Or lady? Yeah, so I don't know, around 11 we're gonna be doing a Queendom. Oh Jesus, pretty loud. A Queendom review, but I'm just kinda messing around.
He's right here.
Just kinda messing around until then. Sorry, I gotta turn this down, this is loud. Oh my god. Or not, Jesus. I was waiting so long to be able to stream this game because it's buggy as hell. And it's still buggy. But hopefully we can stream it.
Championship that gained a lot of prestige.
Whoa! Why is it so fast?
Yeah, I mean, once a title match is called by yours truly, you know it finally matters in our industry.
Well, you're certainly not Mr. Modest today, are you, Corey?
Golly, that sounded rough.
I don't know why it's in super fast speed.
Pays off.
It's so fast. I have no idea.
She's got an answer for that. My goodness, did you hear that chop? Oh, look at that scope slam.
Do I think Sasha will... Probably. Sasha will probably be there.
Talk about dismantling your opponent. Ah, drop kick to the spine. From the top, senton! Things taking a turn for her now. Yeah, but too soon to be worried. Into the turnbuckle.
I mean... I hope Sasha's there. Otherwise, it's, I don't know what you'd call it. It's just a giant prank on every single wrestling fan. Yeah, for some reason, I feel like they've done Kairi versus Sasha a million times in WWE, but it feels different. It's definitely going to be a disappointment. I feel like one way or the other. That's for sure. Yeah, I wish there was a format button when you make the cut, when you put your pictures in. That's for sure. Oh, whatever. And the Mixed Max Challenge arena. That's yeah. Utami's definitely the dude here. She's definitely a total bro. Come on, don't screw me over. Don't freeze. This game is unplayable. But God, I wish it was freaking playable. It looks like so much fun. Oh no, it froze. Oh no. Come on. Well, that's trying to figure itself out. Later, we're going to be, if you're just joining in, probably around like a half hour, we're going to be doing our talking about Queendom and whatnot. Just when I was, I wanted, bro, Tommy broke the game. I like how some of the pictures are normal, and then some of them are like this. I don't know. I think bro Tommy broke the game. Hey, where's Shuri? You gotta have a Shuri, right? Probably. No. All right, bro, Tommy, you'll have to do. Ooh, I kind of a dude. Utami got, oh Jesus, Julius, 10 times the size. Utami got so screwed. I threw some stuff at a wall. Dude, Shuri, I keep saying Shuri. Kairi tapped so many times. Well, if Shuri gets the same treatment Utami did, Shuri might as well not exist. Utami lost the red belt and then just disappeared for 8 months. I can't name a single one of her matches. Why is it so... I must have a... I can't tell if there's a setting I have on or if the game's just this buggy where it's in like triple speed, but I don't feel like crashing the game trying to figure it out.
And from Japan, you, Tommy. It's a big fight feel here tonight as the title.
Wow. I like they blur out her name. Shuri is always a goofball. I don't know how to play this game, by the way.
And the referee is motioning for these superstars to get into the ring where this match belongs. I'm not sure there's any reasoning. All right, snapping her back to reality. This isn't a
play. Oh!
And there's an argument to be made.
Tommy's not fucking around. This is like, if you thought the hardest mode of the hardest difficulty of the game was too easy, you just play it on like triple speed. I'm playing this on Steam. It's a PC, so you think it would work.
What's coming next? She's just getting worked over right now. And you know now she must rethink her strategy. Middle rope, she comes up empty.
God, this is ridiculous.
Both arms trapped.
Oh my god, it's Tommy's so cool though.
Way to get out of harm there. Stiff kick. Stomping. Ouch.
Ow.
Can she capitalize? Well, that's one way to leave the ring, I suppose. Oh, jaw shattering.
Oh my god, she's killing her. Oh my god. Fuck Julia, I guess. Why am I even bothering? I can't. Oh my god, she's not letting go. I don't even know why I was bothering fighting a submission and you can't tap out.
Oh yeah, CES are really getting fired up.
What's funny is this was a bug like months ago when I tried to stream this game.
And now she's climbing to the top turn, soaring. Oh god! A completely ill-advised decision. Likely gonna pay for it in the rest of this match.
This game looks so good though. She's saying, let's go. I wish it worked. It's like I don't even know the controls. Oh. Like, I wish I could make this WWE game my just a Stardom game.
At this point, this is incredibly ill-advised. You're in the middle from the top. Double axe handle. Eye to the counter.
God damn, and Tommy just unbeatable.
She had it scouted.
Headbutt, headbutt. Oh, Julia loves the headbutts.
Yeah, she is. Great counter. She could be turning her fortunes around.
When's the last time? Oh, the title match. Wow, what a squash match. Yes. You, Tommy, the Stampede champion. I should play as Izumi because it's such that it's like playing in high speed. All right, well, that was an epic. Oh my god, you know it would be hilarious. I should do like a tornado match. It'll feel on the with the bug. It'll actually feel like Fire Pro or something. It'll be insane with all the bots. Okay, got Tam Nakano. Just doing random. Oh, there's a. Oh, God, a four-way team. That's cool. Oh, and Julia. Yep, I'm sure they'll get along great together. Then we have Hanan teaming with. Nah, you gotta be a Stardom wrestler. Rina! I like that. Some of these pictures are killing me. Yeah, I don't understand how the rating system in this game works. Like, I think the highest person in the game, because they're trying to do, like, the stupid, what would you call it? Like, what every other sports game does with the packs. They have a dumbass rating system. Sure. A title match? There's no titles. Oh, arena. I'm surprised they have all these like old arenas since WWE pretends like if it's not building up to this year's WrestleMania, it might as well not even have happened. All right, so this is going to be a buggy piece of garbage, but hopefully it runs. Yo, what's up, dude? All the way from Russia. That's cool. I added Stardom Woman to my GM mode. Yeah, that's awesome. See, the problem I have with... I don't know if it's just the PC thing, but I can't get anything to work. Sorry, I'm just laughing that Julia's picture is so giant you can barely see Tam poking out in the back, which is hilarious. I also like the Koguma poking out. Somehow Kairi is perfect. Like, that's a surprise. Let's hope this actually runs. This buggy... Kairi versus... Yeah, everyone else is giant. Or, you know, it could be perspective. Ram looks like an actual demon. I have a strong feeling this just isn't gonna load, but I wish it would, because this would be hilarious. Come on. You can do it. Load. Oh, here we go. Only took 45 minutes for the loading bar to load. Now, how long will the match take to load is the real question. I would love the... I just call them the Hanan sisters, but yeah, that, I would love if they were... Oh my god, don't tell me it froze. I would love if they were the new bloodline. I could barely get a one-on-one match to... It wasn't even working properly. I don't know why I thought this would work. Yeah, let's give this a... Yeah, maybe I'll go in the settings and do something. Whoops. Here we go, Steam. Here we go. Clap, clap. And it's not my PC. I got a great PC, supposedly. It's just this garbage game. All right, let's see which loads first. If Fire Pro loads first, that's a win. Oh no, they both. You know when one game isn't loading, so you decide to try to make two games compete to load? That's a good idea. That's good for the old PC. And they both loaded at the same time. It's like football. Sometimes, like, a guy's not performing, so, like, the running back is having really shitty numbers, so you bring in another running back to the team. I just threatened WWE that I was going to play Fire Pro, and it just loads right up. Just turn everything off. This game doesn't have graphic settings. That might be the dumbest thing I've ever seen. I don't know. Whatever. All right, if 8 people breaks the game, how about a tag match? And Tam and Julia is still the that's hilarious. That's still going to be the tag team. Oh, graphics are in extras, because, yeah, thanks. Where's extras at? Yeah, because that makes sense. It's already on 30 FPS. Awesome. Shadows. Oh my god. Shadows? Why is there shadows in a wrestling game? Just zero audience. I just want the game to work. Most, actually, yeah, whatever. Why would I need shadows in a wrestling game? It's not a FPS. Versus Hikari's huge face. And I think I have a Saki that looks like a monster too. Oh my god, that's terrifying. They've become one. Oh no, and now Hikari's taken back over. Human bodies produce shadows. Fair. That is a good reason to have shadows in a video game. I literally turned. I feel like the turning the crowd and shadows off should be plenty to make this run smoother. Oh my god, and then Tam's... How did Tam get back in front of Julia? This is hilarious. This is like turning to be the only entertaining part of this game. Hikari's the real face of colors. For a second there, Hikari's face was Saki's face. Shadow Miyu? What's a Shadow Miyu? Is that like Dark Link? Oh, don't. Alright, I'm gonna give it a minute. No, I'm not. All right, I gave up on that game. We're going with Fire Pro. I tried. I gave it three chances. It couldn't handle it. Just couldn't handle it all. Oh my, oh no. Oh no, that music can't possibly be copyright friendly. Oh well. All right, start. Good old Fire Pro. It just works. Alright, we got Sami Zayn. Jushin Thunder Liger. Or however you say that. Thunder Liger. I think that's EO. And, this just turned into Tokyo Joshi Pro Wrestling Simulator. Michelle McCool. Asuka. Is that Bruiser Brody? Luke Harper? Eddie Guerrero? And Shawn Michaels. So there you go. Oh, come on, Shawn. Oh, come on, Sean. You can't get punked out by Undertaker's wife. Like, Shawn Michaels can't win here. Either he's beating on a woman, or he just got body slammed by a woman. Oh, nice double team. Give up? Wow. Oh my god. Bunkhouse Buck. That's hilarious. Oh my god, Asuka's a machine. Suplex. Oh, don't keep tagging out. That's lame. Oh my god. Asuka's more bulky than Liger. She's jacked. This seems like a match that could actually happen in Japan on like a indie show. Give up. Oh, Some of the animations in this game are so brutal sometimes. Oh, big boot! You know the best part about this game is it actually runs. Yo, Io's jacked too. Oh, moonsault! It's over! Oh, 2.9 count. That was close. Yeah, this is a DDT match for sure. Yeah, I thought it was Bruiser Brody. I'm going to pretend it's Bruiser Brody because that's funnier. That's Luke Harper. Oh my god, a knockout punch. This is so silly. Boo. Wait. I don't know if I'm supposed to like Sammy or not. Yay. Boo. Oh, and they both go down. Oh, what a counter. Dude, the animations on this game are so smooth for something that looks like it can be made with MS Paint. I wish Super Strong. That's a tongue twister. Super Strong Stardom Giant Machine. I could play this game. I don't know. I'll play one. I don't know any of the controls though, because I buy wrestling. I like hoard wrestling games. I don't actually play them. Yeah, I would really love to see a super strong, super tall Stardom machine, whatever her name is, versus Lady C. Now that would be a whole lot of centimeters in one match. Tap! I love that Eddie has no problem beating on a woman. Oh, he's not even in the match anymore. That was dirty. Ooh, what a block. Ow! Sean. He's got a grudge against Michelle McCool. That's for sure. Yo! Eo's the only person that goes for pins. Oh my god! It's 4-on-1! Ref! Ref, what the fuck? Get some control! What the fuck, ref? Not cool. I must have paid him off or something. Come on, Eo. Nice. Way to flop. In a ladder, man. Alright. Super strong Stardom giant machine versus Lady C in a Natsupoi on a pole match. Where you gotta climb the top rope and then Natsupoi is on the top of a pole and then if you can bring down the Natsupoi, you get to take her home with you. I love how the animations in this game are so, like, I don't know, what would I call them, like claymation, but yet at the same time they can be so smooth. Oh, Sammy, no! Why? He just booted his own teammate in the face. See, if I played this game, I wouldn't even know how to do that. Yo! Luke Harper just did his finish and left. Oh no, Sammy's done for. Oh, he's got a little ooze left in him. A poi. Doesn't that just sound like a good gimmick for a showcase? A poi on a pole match. Kick, punch, kick. Oh no, is this never gonna end? Is this like a game? Is this... Yo, Asuka is a beast! Is this one of those games where the CPU just keeps getting in the ring and breaking up every pin? This is like a time limit. What did you think was gonna happen? You challenge Okada. Of course he murdered you. I love when they make the tag and they just get to it's. They just get to do a two-on-one for like 45 seconds and murder the other team. Oh, that is a good match. They both love the fedoras. They're both fedora scumbags. Oh my god, it's a free-for-all! Ow! Jushin! Alright, that was pretty cool. The stream trusts more than Forbidden Door. Not exactly a lie. I love how this match has just evolved into every time there's a pin, it just turns into a brawl for all. Oh! Was that a closed fist? Come on, ref. Oh, it's over! Oh, wrong corner. That could have been it. Red Belt Hanan is definitely going to happen when Julia decides to stop wrestling. He just pulled a chair out of his ass. Come on, EO. Finish him off. Oh, no. They both can't. How does EO take longer to get up? I thought there'd be like a time limit, but I don't think there is. But I'm too committed at this point. I gotta see who comes out on top from this Tony Khan fever dream match. I would love to see Hina and Rina as the tag champs. I really liked Rina and Hanan when in the tag league last year, where they hated each other. Or more specifically, Rina hated Hanan. Stunner! The pink mist. I love how they get to the point where like they're too exhausted to stand back up. Whoa! Imagine, how do you take a suplex and turn that into a bump to the outside? That's impressive. Even know who's supposed to be in the ring right now. This match is just complete. And now there's weapons. Now there's kendo sticks. What is happening? What a main event. Now there's more kendo sticks. I don't even know what a kendo stick is. Where would you buy a kendo stick? They sell them at like the local market. Well, order was finally restored. Kind of. Just give him a super kick and call it a day. Hey, V4. Oh, super kick! That's what I said. Just super kick and call it a day. It's over. I don't know when we're going to do a power ranking. Sometime soon. We were waiting for after Queendom. At this point, I just like, someone please win the match. Please. Anybody. This is turning into an Okada match. I could see Hanan beating a Uso. Maybe not Roman. Maybe Sammy. I'd watch a Sammy versus Hanan match. At this point, I feel like I'm just committed to seeing how this plays out. I I like how Luke Harper just keeps adding more weapons to the pile. Ow! What's the opposite of a fight forever chant? Enhanced Solos WWE. I mean, she's definitely, besides, I don't know, Britt Baker, she's probably better in the whole AEW women's roster. Please stop fighting. Wins, make it stop. Oh my god. They're just getting to the point where they can't even stand up. Sammy, you can be our hero. Just go for the pin. Game is so retarded. Ooh, Hanan vs. Shida would be really good. Come on, Io. Please put us all out of our misery. Cannot believe this has been going this long. It's gotta end sometime, right? Like now? Like now, please? Please now! Do it! Like at 20 minutes, I'm like, oh, maybe there's got to be a time limit. Hopefully it's 30, and now we're at 40. And then 10 minutes from now, I'll be like, please tell me it's an hour. That was a sick move, though. Michelle McCool goes to the top rope, chickens out, tags in Asuka, gets murdered by Asuka. This match made Sean lose his smile. Well done. Oh, thank the Lord. It's finally over. You know the most messed up part about that, guys, is I was looking at my messages and I didn't see who won the match. Total letdown. But if you guys wanted to stick around, we were about to get into our Queendom review, reaction, whatever you want to call it. But man, that Fire Pro is so much more fun when you don't actually play Fire Pro. Hello.
Did you watch Fire Pro play itself?
Well, for the last, I was waiting for you to get on, and at first I was just trying to do a quick little Stardom match, and you know, I just got to give up on the WWE game. It just doesn't want to, you know, be a video game. But Fire Pro is fun. I made the mistake of doing.
It was hard.
I made the mistake of doing an 8-person tag match that went 40 minutes.
Did you play it, or did you just set it on computer versus computer?
I just computer versus computer, and I I picked random characters, so it ended up being a Tony Khan like fever dream match. It was like Bruiser.
Oh, I thought you kept doing Hikari Shimizu versus Zumi, and you're gonna keep replaying it until Hikari won.
That's hilarious. And that's a good segue. Wasn't that the opener? Oh no, there's openers. Yeah, so what'd you want to get into? Talking to, I'm assuming, Queendom, right? The biggest wrestling event of the year?
Yeah. However.
Anyway, I love these comments, though. 7 stars in the Tokyo Dome.
I'll have to go back and watch that. For length only, right? Isn't that how the star rating is? It can only be 7 stars if it lasted over an hour.
Dude, it really makes me... I was going about it all wrong. It's like, I actually spent, like, a lot of money on the WWE game. It's a AAA game. And apparently, people in Microsoft Paint have made better characters than WWE can with their billion-dollar corporation.
Yeah, I just, I like the way that's set up with the, I don't know how to do that on a video, the little WAV files at the end. I'm actually just gonna set it up. I wanted to bring up my news site, too. The thing is, you gotta be careful, because they just had their, I think today they had, or yesterday, depending on how it falls, there's, like, the New Year's show. I didn't want any spoilers for that.
Sorry, I can't hear anything over. You know how sometimes I'll be looking at something and then like the hearing disappears because I'm like hyper focused?
Was Lady C back on TV?
No, I'm just looking at my new Red Queen.
All right. Well, let's, once we get into it, it'll feel good. I'm still recovering from a couple days no sleep. I did also want to say, if you wanted to redo the attendance podcast, because I don't remember it. and it wasn't a drinking issue. It was just...
It was,
being it was up, a... It was, yeah, it was a...
Being up for 3 days issue. Straight issue.
Yeah, babysitting a sump pump so my basement doesn't flood issue. So still recovering, but nothing... beer and a bang energy can't fix, right?
Nothing a 40 so, minute damn, I wish you would have got on a couple minutes earlier. Nothing a Fire Pro match that gets you hyped up.
You know what we should actually do is, because I barely know how to play and you barely know how to play, we should just like do the same exact thing. Well, not the same exact, but even if we did a one-on-one against each other, I have a sad feeling that would be 5 hours as we try to figure out how to pin each other. Like, all right, I figured out punch. Well, which one is it? I'm not telling you. I figured it out.
Yeah, you'd think if we're a game where, like, punch is a button and then, like, everything else is another button, like, you would be able to figure it out pretty easy, but it's such a complex game.
Based. And I don't like playing video games, like, sober, so the timing-based games start getting messed up. Yeah, so if you want to redo your attendance one, that's fine. Plus, the sound might have been a little shitty because we were on a different system. But once we get going, it should all work out. You had like 13 people watching you play that, or watching you not play that game.
Yeah, I think I drew more than Forbidden Door.
Well, that's probably not true. I had 13 TVs watching it in my house. I was trying to get all the ratings up, but I turned it off for the guys' matches, just trying to get the extra ratings for the ladies. So let's welcome everyone to the Stardom Fan Podcast. I'm Mark.
And I wanted to say something that's probably would have got us banned, but I won't. I'm Juno.
And today we are gonna, review Queendom, which we watched.
I can't not say it. Someone said free Andrew Tate and Rossi, and then I just had the thought of like, is that the new Pizzagate?
I don't know. That's something I don't really follow.
Oh. Well, if you don't know, Andrew Tate got arrested, and there's this guy, like, he's like a social media guy, and he got arrested in Romania, and like, you don't get any of the details, but basically it was hilarious because he was going back and forth on Twitter with like Greta Thunberg, like, you know, the crazy, like, the planet's gonna die, like that 13-year-old. And he's like, oh, I have all these pizza boxes, and I'm gonna make sure I don't recycle them. And then basically the Romanian police saw that video and was like, hey, because the pizza boxes were obviously, like, they could tell from, like, where they were from. Like, hey, he's in Romania. We've been meaning to arrest that guy. So I was like, hi, he got arrested because of pizza. By the way, he made a whole deal about, I'm not going to recycle my pizza boxes. I'm like, dude, you're not supposed to recycle your pizza boxes. So good job, dude. You're pro-environment. You're supposed to throw them in the trash. Anyways.
But first.
Intros are always in order.
Before we get into that, it's worth saying for the podcast listeners, if you hop on the YouTube, the community tab has been blowing up. Christmas had like 15 posts for some reason. New Year's even crazier? Or was that just a fever dream of a whole lot of our ladies being rabbits until you figured out, is it like the year of the rabbit or something? What am I missing?
Yeah. The community tab's fun. If you don't check it out, I'm scrolling through it right now. I try to post up on it every day. It's fun. Where else are you? It's basically like our own little Stardom fan. What'd you call it? Like social media.
Yeah, normal people would probably do it on like.
There's not even
Twitters or Instagrams, but everything's on YouTube, so it works out perfectly.
But look at this Rudolph.
Look at that Rudolph.
Now look at this Rudolph. That's a Rudolph. That's a Rudolph who gets shit done.
Bro, the bro Rudolph.
Yeah, bro Tommy. I thought Reddit was, what is the catchphrase? It's like the front page of the internet. There's a Stardom. Oh, well, I don't know. There's not even really a good subreddit, is what I'm trying to get at, for Stardom. But there is the YouTube community page.
I was going to say, I'm sure there is. They just don't like you. So you just started your own thing.
Now that's a reindeer.
And that's all the YouTube always has something exciting. Stardomfan.com, there is actually new gifts added, so that is fun. And by the time the podcast is released, the nominees of the Shimmies, the Stardom Fan 2022 awards, should be up. And there is a small correction. For some reason, we left out Tomoka Inaba. Should either be, in my opinion, up for Rookie of the Year or definitely get the O.
I like both those options, but you can't be in both. Is what we decided.
Yeah, I think we got a little loosey goosey with those rules by the time it all ended.
But so maybe she can be. She can get no.
Yeah, well, obviously. So that was all the housekeeping I had. Did you have anything before you wanted to get into the show?
Yeah, how's the pic? How's the video quality? Because the way I'm looking at it, it's like really low. But the other thing I'm it looks like it's streaming really well. But then I have it also up on another tab, and it looks in bad picture quality.
Oh, it's good. I can see all the lady C's and all that stuff.
Well, that's good. All right, so what do we want to get into? You want to get into Queendom, or it's like I could nerd out about numbers, but I don't know how that.
Let's do Queendom first. I don't think it'll be too long, and then we can do the attendance.
Cool.
And then from there, you can play Fire Pro again. Let me get my thing up. Yeah, and then just some thoughts and whatnot, because you know I have some thoughts on the year too, and so it might be fun to wrap up this Queendom, wrap up the year, and what Stardom Fan has going on next year. I would like to say actually, congratulations on a full year, Juno. It's been fun, and I think. I don't know when the timestamp is, but technically you're less than an hour away from the birthday of your first ever uploaded music video to Stardom Fan YouTube. So that should probably deserve a repost or a link in the community tab. Because if people haven't seen it, I mean, it's definitely worth seeing your first video.
The first video or the first? All right, the first video ever or the Utami video?
I thought the Utami one was first.
No.
Was Waka first?
Waka was our first.
Yes! Well, that is also amazing. Oh my god. I'm actually happier. That was your first piece. I thought it went to Utami, then Waka. Oh my god. That was anyone who ends up watching that, the fact that you brought that to life made me so happy. Because for the longest time, being a Final Fantasy fan, and you got to ride the heavy metal Ride the Chocobo music from like Final Fantasy 13, right?
Yeah.
I'm like, every time Waka does that move where she hides or jumps on the girl's back, I just can't stop thinking Ride the Chocobo. So once you put it to music, I knew we had something special here. That was just the beginning. Oh dear God.
When's the last time you're not allowed to call her main event Miyu unless she's in Kyoto? Because I think that's the only city she's allowed to wrestle in.
Finger bang Miyu?
Yeah, finger bang. Did you have anything to say about this? I'm just scrolling through some of the pictures. Did you have anything to say about this Stardom Rumble?
No, I'm okay to
pretend it never happened. Cool.
Unless there was a spot you know. I mean, I guess the only thing worth I must have blacked out because I don't remember the pineapple being on Rina's head. That's not good. Unless
I don't remember. I remember her putting the pineapple on her head, and I don't remember her liking it.
Have you done enough side by sides? I was gonna say the big new muscle machine girl.
Yeah,
we thought was Lady C, but I'm like, I don't know.
Well, no, Lady C got.
I think she was better than Lady C.
Well, Lady C got eliminated first in the Rumble. I don't know, and then the last contestant was the super strong giant Stardom machine, and she ends up, even though you'd think there'd only be one winner, the referee just wanted to have a cigarette and forget this ever happened. So he decided the last two contestants just get to win.
Yeah.
But the super strong Stardom giant machine, I think her and Lady C would have a really good match.
So it's either, we assume it's not Lady C.
Oh my God.
She looks ripped. The muscle machine girl.
If you go on the results page, they usually do like a play by play. It's like the Stardom Rumble. It's like a dissertation.
That's funny. Well, not counting the Rambo, the warm up the crowd match was fantastic. And I can't believe it was only 9 minutes because it was awesome.
It's because they're so high speed.
Oh, they were so high. Well, yeah. And I thought Hikari spending all that time in Mexico, being the luchadora and amazing, I thought she was going to get her. But Izumi once again finds a way to sneak past her.
I was laughing.
I mean, she did almost rip her arms out.
I think you had, one of us had the joke that, yeah, Hikari spent some time in Mexico. I'm like, what are the odds that she was just wrestling with, like, the Lucha Brothers? And she's like, I'm going to get so good at Lucha. And then she realized, oh, I can't do any of that. And then she just went back to doing her old moves.
Maybe. She did. She went to the top a bunch of this match. Oh, you know what? You know what, though? This might have been the first time we've seen her in a singles match. I mean, she's always doing stuff with the Angels or Colors or Saki. So, you know, to see 9 minutes of Hikari, definitely can't wait to see more. And she's definitely more flexible than Thekla because her arms didn't pop out.
Yeah, I'm going to have one crit. It was a really good match. I'm going to have, like, one criticism. It and it's the just winner? Like, I guess. It's. I don't know. Izumi does all sorts of high speed stuff, and then her finisher is just an armbar, which could be if she did a Ronda, like a real armbar, like a Ronda Rousey, like high speed armbar where she just like snaps the arm back. Oh, that's probably like really dangerous for her. That would be cool, but it's like, yeah, all this stuff happens in like a 9 minute span, and then it ends with a 45 second like armbar that's like, I don't know, it just kills it for me. It's like, if you're going to be high speed, just go all the way. You can't be a high speed champion and your finisher is an armbar that like people have to sell for 3 minutes for the match to end. Other than that, it's
usually
really good.
Only high speed. Yeah, it was good. Usually the high speed's like the first 2 minutes and then they slow it down.
No, not this match.
The hair extensions start falling out.
And then it gets like hazardous to run around the ring. I do like when the hair extensions start flying around and the ref has to be instead of focusing on like the calling the match, he's got to like run around sweeping freaking Dollar Tree extensions out of the ring.
Dollar Tree extensions. Oh, poor Izumi.
Are you watching the stream?
No. I sort of got my own thing up too.
If you go to the results page, the pictures they use for the second match are great because it's Hanan and Koguma doing the bear pose, and then Mayu and Koguma doing the bear pose, and then Kogo and Koguma doing the bear pose, and then the fourth picture is Hazuki slapping the taste out of Kogo's mouth.
Oh, you know what's actually funny is I was going to say that my favorite part of this match is, well, one, Mayu's got a win. But two, my favorite part of the match that I remember was everyone was doing the Kuma shit, and Hazuki was like, hell no. Nah. She doesn't have time for any of that.
Yeah, it's stars versus stars. So Kogan was like, all right, now like Hanan does the bear pose. And then she's like, all right, now go tag in Mayu. And then Hanan's like, okay. I've never had my opponent tell me, like, make me tag out before. And then Mayu does the bear pose, and she's like, okay, that was fun. Now go tag in Kogo. And then she does it, and then Hazuki doesn't even tag. I don't even know if she tags in. She just, like, walks into the ring and is like, all right, enough of this garbage, and just starts beating everybody else up.
Yeah, Hazuki's pretty cool.
And it ends with our favorite curtain jerker, Mayu, getting the win.
Yeah, which is funny, because as we're watching this, I guess I didn't even realize, we're like, the biggest show of the year, and Mayu's in a six-woman tag on the second match? Shouldn't she be in? But I guess since she was, like, in every other match that mattered throughout the year, she was fine to just sort of sit back.
Well, he told her she had to go on first, and it had to be, like, five other knuckleheads in the ring with her, because she would have, like, stolen the show otherwise.
Fair enough.
Like, we can't have you having the best match of the night 3 hours before the main event.
Izumi was almost part of the best match. What do we got? I was super excited for the return of Unagi and Mina.
Ooh, Nagi.
That made me super happy. And then, I don't know, Mina found a couple blondes on her way in. She was out for, she's been out for a couple of months doing rehab, and while getting her face redone, she found a couple blondes to go with it. Like, one nose job and two blondes, please.
Sounds like a good Friday night. Stardom just, Stardom just isn't the same without Mina's Shirakawas. You know?
Mm-mm.
To make the world feel right.
Yeah, but am I excited for this match if we're still seeing her 3 days a week?
Yeah.
No. Okay. Yeah, no. There's something about just this. Sometimes you have to go away for a month, and then it's like super exciting when you come back.
I like my favorite part of the match is Thekla tags in and just walks up to Mina and just grabs her face and is like, still cute, and then slaps her in the mouth.
She's so fucking funny, isn't she? And it's funny because right before she did that, you reminded me that they had that feud where basically the Thekla versus Mina stuff, and Thekla kept saying that she's pretty and weird things like that. I'm like, so the fact that she brought that back, I thought was super funny.
But then after the match, Mina attacks Unagi for no reason and said, Pink Kabuki's over because I got new bitches.
I didn't understand that. She was like, didn't even call when I was injured.
And I think that's how it translates perfectly. I have new bitches now. Right? That's how I interpreted it.
That's probably right.
So basically, I don't know. They're both cosmic. I think Mina's just gonna start her own group pretty soon. She does. That is her own a new group, but she says she's still Cosmic Angel. So unless she just takes over and they kick Tam out, she might be breaking off on her own.
Yeah, none of that really matters, I don't think, right? Because Tam and Natsupoi are on like just a whole different world. Like, there's no way Tam has any idea who's in her group anymore. Nor does she. Can she possibly care?
She can't possibly care.
No.
New Age Weeb said, I expect Xia Brookside to go back to WWE in a few months. That's what we said. We looked up who they were, and that's like, you're like, hey, she was in NXT UK like a couple years ago. And I'm like, ugh. Vince McMahon Jr. over there is gonna watch this show and go, who is that? He's like, well, Mr. H, we actually had her signed in NXT UK a few years ago. Well, who the fuck told me to fire her? Tell that guy he's fired. Sign her to a contract.
I'd like to see him in the ring. The problem is she looks, just like five other girls on that roster and eight other girls on the AEW roster.
True.
Cute as a button, but nothing to stand out.
Nothing makes me happier than knowing about like Vince McMahon just forgetting that he's hired. Like, he forgets that you're on the roster. It's like, who are you? Or he'll forget that Luke Gallows says a thing. Like, apparently he was the Kane. No, it was like there was like a imposter Kane, like that was Luke Gallows, and he's been on and off hired and had different gimmicks for WWE like four or five times, and then he's like finally becomes the Good Brother, and Vince is like, oh, who is this guy? He's like, oh, and then he has to be like, I'm from Japan, sir. Please don't remember I was Festus.
That's super funny. I didn't know. I didn't remember that either. We have a number one contendership match this is when the show really starts heating up.
Yeah, the right team wins. But
yeah,
unfortunately,
this is the first time I'm happy with a win.
Unfortunately, is later on in the show. So Miami gets the win, and they're the new number one contenders for the title. But later on in the show, we find out that they won't get to get their hands on. I was going to say the Tam, but I guess the Natsupoi works too. But on to the main event. We have Utami Hayashishida versus Kairi. Utami got fucked so hard by this referee. Would you agree?
Yeah, Utami won. There's a lot of slow counts. Utami basically kicked Kairi's ass for 14 minutes and 50 seconds. Kairi got a couple lucky shots in, and then they fought to a draw.
They fought to a draw. Okay. There were the end of the match. Kairi, his face is purple from oxygen loss, and she's not moving. And the ref's like, "Kairi, do you want to fight?" He's like, "No, I think she's dead, dude. She probably could have called the match 30 seconds ago."
She had her in a choke that was so tight. It was insane. It looked like the ref was checking her out to make sure she wasn't choking her out legitimately. It was awesome. The take I had from this is, how strong is Kairi supposed to be here? Who did she beat this year? Starlight?
She beat Starlight.
Was that it? I mean, she worked a draw with Saya, and now a draw here, and now at Wrestle Kingdom, what you gonna do? Beat Tam Nakano straight up and have Tam look like the weakest out of the last three she fought? That's weird. But I'm glad Utami didn't lose. That was my fear, is that Kairi can't lose going into Wrestle Kingdom. She could, but it seemed.
It really would have threw a wrench in the plan when the Kairi versus Tam Nakano match is no longer for the New Japan title.
Right?
On Wrestle Kingdom.
That's good. It starts off the year of Utami, 2023. You know, it's a good way to start the year.
It's a good way to end the year.
Yeah, but you're going into the year with some momentum.
Yeah. No, the best part of the match is afterwards. Kairi's going to leave with her belt, and Utami is sticking her hand out, and then Kairi's like, "Oh, you want a handshake? Yeah, that was a good match." And then Utami's like, "No, you idiot," and just points to the title. I want that.
Well, this build worked for Utami and Shuri for a year. Wrestled to a draw, and then wrestled to a double draw, and then Utami beats Kairi somewhere around May. That sounds about right.
Yep. Next up, there was an artist match.
And yes.
The only thing I care to say about it is that Starlight Kid brought her bike from home. It actually used it like you would think you would use a bike in a hardcore match by running all her opponents over.
It actually seemed brutal. This is the Artists Championship match. Prominence versus the Oedo Tai Girls, Momo, Starlight Kid, and Saki Kashima. As far as garbage hardcore matches go, I mean, this wasn't shitty. At least they left the thumbtacks at home and the light tubes.
No, it was shitty.
They didn't cheat any more or less than Oedo Tai normally does.
They started the Prominence started the match by like dumping a bunch of Legos into the ring and then immediately leaving the ring for the referee to swipe them out of the way.
That's his job. He's practically a janitor.
And then we had another match.
Well, I don't think it doesn't hurt to talk about the end of this Artists of Stardom Championship match with Prominence finally catching a win. And the scary part about that is our favorite part of Oedo Tai, it almost without Momo Kid and Saki having the belts and then being on different teams for Triangle Derby. I hope if a split up happens, I mean, those are the best part of Oedo Tai right now. I'd hate to see them end up in different factions.
I think it's time for Starlight to come home to Stars.
Really? Can she still be evil?
Well, she can join the Cosmic Angels.
That doesn't sound good. I don't want anyone to join the Cosmic Angels that I like.
No one deserves that fate. But they're but you said she could still be evil. If she's going to join another faction, it's like, why not go to the heel team? The ultimate heel team.
I think I assumed she was going to make her own.
Yeah, she was going to take Momo and Saki because they were the artist champs, so that just makes sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then Saki goes everywhere with Fukigen because she's just connected by the leash. So Fukigen's got to go with them, right?
Obviously.
And then young OAD. She's already in a team with Rina and Ruaka, so they got to pop over with Starlight.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And that just leaves Natsuko on her pipe.
Yeah, that works. I don't think that's how it's gonna shape up though.
Do you have anything to say about this tag team match for the Goddesses of Stardom tag titles?
Yeah, I mean, when someone you don't really like becomes the champions, that's fine, I guess, because that just means that when Team 7-Up beats Meltier. One, I don't really like Meltier, but I would have really loved when, because my Himi, that just means my Himi's got to win the belt. So I would have loved for them to beat Meltier and take back the Natsupoi, but now they just got to beat 7-Up, and that's fine too. So that'll feel good. And then Meltier will try to challenge my Himi, and then finally my Himi can get the Natsupoi back.
It is possible that Natsupoi just goes wherever the shiny is. Like, wherever the shiny stuff is. She's like, ooh, you got the tag belts? Okay. Unfortunately, there's no chance they're ever breaking up. Now they're doing, like, singles together. They have music albums coming out. Good lord.
That's why you gotta take the Natsupoi.
a poi on a pole match.
That's it. The match, one of the matches that were on the poster advertising this, the Wonder of Stardom Championship match, Saya Kamitani versus Starlight Kid's friend.
Well, hang on. I thought Micah said something that was great. Because the challengers come out after you and Nene are the new tag champions. Micah said, your expiration date passed a long time ago. Those belts don't suit you guys, so you're gonna rot next year, don't you think so? And then in parentheses, audience responds with great applause.
That's funny. I thought she was saying that the belts don't fit around them.
She was saying that their expiration date has long passed, which is hilarious.
Well, that's for sure.
Yeah, Starlight's friend is a really good wrestler.
Yeah, that was good. This was surprisingly good. Maybe not, because Suzu Suzuki had match of the 5-star with Saya, so it could have been a Saya thing. Oh, that's cool, buddy. No, I'm good. Thanks.
Huh. Well, have you thought of this theory? We keep saying that anyone could have a 5-star match with Saya. What if she's the luckiest wrestler on the planet and she just happens to be like a really bad wrestler and she just happens to, like, everyone she wrestles with carries her for the past year and a half?
That's what's been happening?
I mean, when's the last time you've seen her hit a Phoenix Flash?
She doesn't even need to. That's the thing.
That's because it took her... like 30, how long was this match? Oh, 16:33. Man, they do a lot in 15 minutes.
Yeah, like, every match went by really quick. That's what makes Stardom so good. It's like everything is just, I don't know, it feels snappy. It feels good. It's not like when you're watching, I don't know, anything else where there's a point where you start looking at your watch. You're like, all right, let's wrap it up here. It's like, no, nah, not with these shows. And this wasn't even, I didn't even like completely love this. And it wasn't boring.
Yeah. No, I thought it was really good. I thought that,
Haruka, and I was pleasantly surprised with the kid here.
I was, yeah, Haruka's really good. And I'm so surprised because her new blood matches are so garbage, but maybe now I'm coming to realize it might be just be who she's been facing on them.
Yeah, two rookies going against each other when you got a rookie versus a veteran that can really help out. But yeah, I mean, nothing. If anything, a lot of the scary shit was at the beginning where Saya's bouncing around and I'm like, oh, she's gonna fucking kill somebody herself, or like sometimes I don't know, she's doing some goofy shit, jumping off stuff and landing weird. I'm like, she's one of these two are gonna get hurt.
You know, then
it sort of settled down a little bit. It might have been some like early match jitters or something, because once they settled down it turned into a hell of a match.
Yeah, but then my only problem is, like, after the match, Saya always does the same thing. I always think, like, she always has probably one of the best, if not the best match by far in every show she's on. But why do I not think she's, like, on Shuri or Julia or Mayu's level? And it's because Mike, or she calls out Mina. And
she comes across
after,
as a punk, that's why.
Yeah, after every title defense, she's got to, like, look like a little bitch. That's how I put it. She's like, looks, she, like, just gets punked out. She'll cry, and she'll back away from people. I'm like, bitch, you are the Wonder of Stardom champion.
Yeah, so if we didn't touch on it, or if we just assumed it,
they should be lucky to challenge you for the belt. She's like, thank you for, I'm so grateful that I got to wrestle you and beat you. I'm like, yeah, because you're really fucking good. You should be saying thank you to me for wrestling me for my
belt.
That's
what she does. That's definitely something that she's missing in her game is confidence. Or she comes across, I mean, she's in Queen's Quest, for heaven's sakes, with like the bro is the leader. Azumi comes out with attitude. Even
yeah,
Hina had
take,
a little bit of attitude.
Dude,
like, what are you gonna do to me?
That is the best point I think anyone's ever made. Azumi comes out with all the undeserved confidence in the world. Like, take a little lesson from that.
I think I just meant there was a Queen's Quest attitude. And Saya has more of a Cosmic Angel attitude where she just has to cry after every match.
She's got a Waka complex.
I don't understand. So she calls out Mina after she beats Starlight Kid's friend and then offers her a match. See, this is what I don't get. So Saya beats Mina clean in the middle, but just because Saya beat her so bad that she was out for a month, she feels bad and wants to offer her a rematch? Come on, grow a set.
Yeah, you step in the ring with me, you might lose a couple more teeth.
Yeah, exactly. Your hair's going to end up even shorter. that it came where her facial reconstruction surgery came with a new hairdo.
It was on the house.
No. You know what? Actually, her talking to Mina, I don't think, is where it got... That was fine. I just didn't understand why she was calling out Mina. If anything, Mina should have called her out.
If anything, if she was going to call out Mina, she just said, Mina, I hope you have a good deductible. So I'm going to put a couple more holes in that mouth.
But then the white belt champion calls out the futures champion. And then says, are you ready to step up? And then when Ami Soroi comes out and doesn't back down, Saya like starts getting like scared and backing away. I'm like, you called her out. And now you're looking, that's what made me like, come on, Saya, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, she called Ami didn't call Saya out.
No, it took her a couple minutes to get out there. I think she was like undoing her shoes, you know, getting ready to hit the road, and all of a sudden she heard her name on the microphone. She's like, "What?"
Like, yeah,
Saya Kamatani.
She got embarrassed. Didn't Ami, when Ami came out, she's like, "Oh, so you're challenging me?" She's like, "Well, I am the Futures Champion, and I guess I'll take your belt too. Because you're a loser, right, audience?" And then people started clapping.
Yes. I think that's exactly when Saya's attitude changed. As soon as the crowd, that's all they could do is clap still. So, you know, they just might have been clapping because they, who even knows anymore. So, yeah, the fans start clapping. And Saya assumes it's because they want Ami to win. So now she's flustered. She's like, "Oh." Oh, it's fantastic. So Ami goes on to say, "Yeah, I'm gonna take that belt." And then Saya gets more flustered. She's like, "Oh, I thought I was gonna scare you away." And mind you, I don't remember the Hanan who broke every Futures record in the world getting a white belt title shot. But this Ami, who's been what, champion for 2 months and has been in Stardom for less than a year, all of a sudden gets to go against the great Saya Kamatani. I think Saya is just picking her next challenger to tie the Momo record with someone that she thinks is easy. She's going to start picking her own competition and her own easy competition. I like your take. Who should have came out?
Well, before I get to that, I was looking at the pictures, and when she calls out Ami, this picture I'm looking at, Ami, who hasn't wrestled in probably over an hour, is in street clothes, showered and everything, is just standing there in the middle of the ring while Saya, who should be full of like pumped up adrenaline, is like in the corner, like on the second turnbuckle. Like, why did you call someone out and like literally hide in a corner?
I think when it was all said and done, the optics of it, like, I don't know how it looks in stills, but the optics probably were, because she ends up holding up her belt, right? So the optics, I think, were supposed to basically be like, "My belt's higher than your belt," which is almost
just
like,
she's already taller
than
her.
Yeah, well, that's the only thing that made sense to me, why she would do that.
Ami, now, come out here. Well, don't get too close.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know if she tied Momo's record, or if she will be going to tie next time. But Momo has the record for the most white belt defenses, so why doesn't she get a shot? I feel like you do something like set a record that's never been set before, and you're still in the company. When someone's about to break your record, you should have the opportunity to, you know, hold it.
Well, they had, it's not unprecedented. That's, didn't the Angels have that when they were going for the record? Whoever had the previous record, I think had the chance to,
yeah,
Miami Poi? Did they have the chance to stop them?
Yeah,
yeah,
they tied their record by tying.
Yeah, so not only is that like not unprecedented, right?
It's actually precedented.
And makes sense. It's easy storyline. Like, I want to stop you from tying or beating my record. I'm going to come out here and whoop your ass. That's exactly what should have happened.
Come on.
Like,
and you get to...
He's calling out the Futures champion. Like, bring out mother effing Momo with your god darn baseball bat.
And Momo... think about it. Like, I can see Momo not giving a shit about the white belt or the glory, but the opportunity to, like, embarrass, like, Saya Kamatani.
Yeah, this version of Momo doesn't give a shit about the record books.
But
she cares that Saya cares.
But she cares about making Saya cry.
Yeah, so if Saya
the Queen's Quest
cries
mascot,
when she loses.
Yeah, she's just going to take the belt and throw it in the trash.
And all this shitting on Saya Kamatani, and I wanted her to be the Stardom fan number one ranked wrestler, and the last quarter's power rankings. And I still stand by that. Because bell to bell. She's one hell of a wrestler. I just don't get anything she does outside the ring. She has like four. She, when this is all said and done, she's the only champion to hold it for the physical year of 2022. She's going to be probably the longest reigning champion. She's had the belt for over a year, and for some reason, she lacks confidence.
Yeah, you know what?
Are you kidding me?
You know who held the belt longer than a year? Yeah, she defends it like on every single pay per view. Tommy had the belt for over 400 days, like the world championship. And I think she only defended it like 8 or 9 times because, you know what? Like, I'm not a novelty. Like, I'm not a dog. Like, hey, bark and I wrestle. It's like, I'm the world goddamn champion and I wrestle when I want. And please. You think I'm just going to, oh, we got a pay-per-view. We need to sell tickets. And said, oh, Tommy's like, okay, that's nice. Well, pay me and I'll be there.
I think it might be a red belt thing. It just doesn't go up as much because I think, sure.
Sure, he defended it every month too. Like, they're like little toys. Like Rossi,
she wrestled like 14 times or something like that for it.
Rossi says jump, and they say how high. Like, bro, Tommy doesn't do what you tell her to do. She defends the red belt when she wants to.
10 times. All right, this was Queendom was Shuri's 11th defense. And Saya's 12th. Yeah, so they were about the same. So, yeah, you're right. Utami, bro, Utami's just, you know, on my time. Before we get into the main event, I need a quick second break to check on the dog. This is what you get for going live. I'll be right back.
What happens when you go live is you say, hey, I think we're going to do a live stream. Should we plan stuff out? Of course not. Let's just go with the flow. That'll always work out. Hey, what's up, Chris? We're taking a little break. Read through some comments here. Azumi. I feel. I know you just guys are messing with me with these Azumi comments. So if they call her tall, Saya, what is the other Saya? She's short Saya? Ooh, Mayu has the most defenses. Well, I did read somewhere in an article, someone asked Mayu about, because she has all these title defenses for the high speed belt. And she's like, what do you feel about this new generation? I guess she's assuming she's talking about Natsupoi, Starlight, and Azumi. About this new generation of like high-speed wrestlers. And she's like, well, it's not really fair to compare them to me. It's a different time. I actually had to defend my belt. But, you know, it's cool. I mean, they can defend it like once a month. Maybe every couple, 2 months. Drip God Utami. I've seen people call Utami Big Sis for some reason. I want to think that's related to the Big Daddy show.
Maybe, but she was the little sis in the Big Daddy show.
Well, now she's.
Jeez, doesn't anyone know the Big Daddy continuity?
Oh.
Didn't anyone else spend hours and hours and days researching Big Daddy?
No one else spent days and days and weeks trying to figure out how to watch this show. It's never been recorded, but everyone's seen.
Before we go on, might as well catch up on the chat.
I get
sidetracked.
Big Daddy. So for those who don't know, you could check out, we did a Meet the Wrestler Utami video. It's actually pretty good. And basically, Utami's family was like on a reality show for her whole childhood. So she just had cameras following her and her family around everywhere they went. Because the dad is called Big Daddy, and he's got like 18 kids. And now, the funniest part of her interviews is people used to say, hey, aren't you Big Daddy's daughter? And now they say, hey, aren't you Tommy's dad?
It was funny. Yeah, it's worth listening to the podcast because we did a or finding it on video because we did a lot of research for it. And there's a lot of things you wouldn't expect. Like, she grew up on TV, and when she said she wanted to be a wrestler, like, even her family was like, are you sure? You're pretty shy. And it's like, as good as she is, you wouldn't realize that she's shy in real life. You know, little things like that is sort of fun.
Hey, you want to plug the Patreon?
Patreon.com/StardomFan. And for just a dollar, I could say thank you to you. And there is other great tiers. but I was going to end up thanking everyone in the chat anyways as I catch up here.
Well, because
Angelo is, if I'm gonna believe that anyone of the Stardom Fan fans bought themselves a Starlight Kid towel, it has to be that man right there, or a blanket, keep it warm with the Starlight Kid blanket.
Because our friend Chris Minji says, when are we going to get the next Meet the Wrestler? And it's been so busy with, like, the holidays and whatnot, trying to get... Like, we haven't even done a power ranking in forever. But if you would look at the... we got a couple tiers here. Maybe give us a nice little donation, and we'll do whatever video you want us to do, even if it's an Izumi video.
No, that was going to be, like, the $10 tier to run a video on Izumi, but I ran out of time writing it up.
Well, get your money in now while it's still cheap. For $5, you can get a Izumi video before it jumps up to 10.
Enigma makes a good point. I'm just playing catch up here. New Blood needs to have a singles title, and that must have been when you're talking about Miyu. So is that's they're doing that thing, huh? Where they're doing a tag belt? That does make sense. Why would they do that before a singles title?
The what now?
Oh, New Blood in their titles. Hey, bud.
I don't know, because New Blood's its own thing.
I'll be right back.
Well, I had no influence on the Patreon. I just woke up and it's like, hey, that's kind of the benefit of Mark over here, his butt basement flooding and him having to babysit a pump for 3 days. He's like, you know, I got a lot of time on my hands at 3 a.m. I made a Patreon. So if there's a $1 thank you tier, or it's just like throw us a buck every month if you like what we do, there's a $3 producer tier. Well, you'll get a thank you on our podcast, and you get producer credits. And for $5 a month, you get a thank you on our podcast, and you're in the credits. And once a month, we will honor your request for a topic of a podcast, video, or live stream of your choice.
I would like to throw in there for, like, the producer tier and above. I mean, this is real producer credits. Like, you just put this on your IMDb, your LinkedIn, that you are a Stardom Fan producer at this point. And if anyone comes up to it, thanks, buddy. Like, we'll back you. Like, if anyone says that's not a real credit, come talk to us. And it's Stardom Fan. Mark at StardomFan.com or Juno at StardomFan.com. And we can assure you that these are legit producer credits. All right, I'll run back. I don't want to ruin the flow of the Queendom. I'll go back through the chat in a second.
I was going to
have a little fun.
I knew you were going to hate the end of this match. I surprisingly didn't end up hating it as much as I thought you would, but I knew you were going to hate Julia, because we both assumed she was going to win the red belt, and then I was going to have to be a $5 donator to get the Julia video.
Your money works as good as anybody else's, pal. I was your first super chat, just throwing it out there.
Yes, you were.
All right, the main event of Queendom. Oh, it's a fine main event, right? I know, it's like I'm torn, because didn't Churi already, like, destroy, like why is this even happening? Like, well, okay, Julia won the 5-star. Okay, that's why it's happening. But, like, really? So, Julia's been mad at Shuri because Julia got pinned to lose their belts. And then Shuri was like, yeah, I'm good. I'm going to take these two girls of yours and we're going to start our own thing. And then,
because look
like
at
a couple months later, Shuri whoops her Julia's ass in a pay-per-view. Uh-huh. And then Julia still hasn't had enough.
Yeah, well, those are all good points. But if you would look at my screen, you would see that. Just look at her. That's your answer. Look at her. That's like, if you wonder, if you were ever wondering, like, why she even, like, any, why she's getting a push or anything, or why she beat this person, or blah, 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 or why she's probably making more money than anyone in the company. Look at her.
Well, yeah, Julia wins. And I was happier about it.
Well, Julia wins.
afterwards. Well, you're showing the picture, so, like, for podcast, you know, just throw it out there. Before we say anything about the match, I was happier like when it was over, and well, boy, did they cry and hug a lot. But I mean, that was a lot of adrenaline, and they kicked the shit out of each other. Yeah. Or actually, Julia kicked the shit out of Shuri. And if there was an Okada like company man or company woman, that
it would be
Julia
Shuri.
Would be it. Well, Shuri, like, Julia basically came out and did an Okada final or finale, where Okada usually comes out and is like, how did everyone like the wrestling show, and I'm gonna make wrestling big in Japan and the New Japan. So that's basically what Julia did. She came out and was like, I am gonna fill arenas and this and that. So I mean, if there's somebody to, if she's wants to take Stardom, put it on her back and fill the big arenas, hey, I'm on board with Team Julia if she brings Stardom to a higher level, I guess.
Listen, I knew Julia was going to win when she came. Didn't she come back? When did she come back? I know it was when Konami left. So that was like a year ago.
I knew Julia was going to win she got pinned by Koguma.
Didn't they?
And they split up.
Didn't she come back on the last? No, I don't know when she came back. It was like a big shit. Maybe. Sound Queendom, whatever, it doesn't matter. When she came back and she faced Konami on Konami's last match, and she's wearing all red, I'm like, oh no, like, you gotta wear every red belt champion's gotta match the title. Yeah. So when Tam starts deciding to like put in the red hair extensions, like, look out.
That's a good call. But yeah, man, this match was 30 minutes and it was awesome. You know what I didn't realize? Was this a 30-minute match that went 29 minutes and 51 seconds?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. That is insane.
I liked the... Oh, two parts of the match stuck out specifically where... I don't know if it's on per... It's Shuri is just too nice. Like, there was a part of the match where Julia was gonna cripple her friend by giving her a pile driver through a table, and then Shuri reversed it, picked her up for a pile driver, and at the last second, like, bails and picks up Julia. So Shuri goes crashing through the table with Julia having a nice comfortable Shuri to break her fall. And then later in the match, Shuri picks up Julia on her shoulder and starts running towards the corner, and like she's gonna like lawn dart Julia's head into the corner, and then just like stops and just drops her like safely,
yeah,
to Shuri the ground.
Bails. She's like, yeah, I'm not breaking my friend's neck. Yeah, she didn't have the killer instinct to finish this match.
Julia had no problem dumping Shuri on her head.
She had no problem giving her an exploder into the cleared out fans, like on through 15 rows of chairs off the damn
10
entrance way
off the
dude
6-foot stage.
Yo, there's no fuck.
So I wish Shuri would just go had that killer mentality, but she couldn't do that against her friend. And then Julia played her Julia mind game. So she's like, Shuri, you're so nice. We're friends. I'm like, this bitch literally put on Momo masks and was assaulting people with sledgehammers. Like, I didn't forget about that.
Oh my God. If there's a me, myself, and Irene of Stardom, it's me, myself, and Julia. You have no idea which Julia you're going to get. Is it Pirate Julia? Is it Badass Bella Julia?
Julia,
can we get a second of GI Julia? I mean, you don't have to shave your head. Just put the fucking head on again. That was cool.
Julia broke up their tag team while they were world tag team champions because she was jealous that Shuri was the world champion. And then all of a sudden she wins the belt and she's like, Shuri, we're such good friends.
Well, she doesn't have to be jealous anymore. If you scroll through the pictures, this looks like a 50-50 match. But while I'm watching this 30 minutes, I think I was somewhere around the 28-minute mark. I said to you, Jesus Christ, Shuri is getting her ass kicked this entire match. I felt like...
It's just your bias.
My bias of Shuri... Actually, my bias is I feel like Shuri, during her title reign, fought from underneath way too much. I would have loved to see more badass UFC Shuri just knocking people out in 3 minutes.
I felt like Julia... But that was the whole match. The whole time. No, that's...
Julia kicking her ass?
No, Shuri was dominating Julia the whole match until, like, every time she'd go for a big move, she would, like, bail or chicken out or, like, only hit half of it, and then Julia would come back and try to kill Shuri. But I think Shuri
the big impact moves.
Shuri, I notice, is the arm, like the hands, her fingers, her knee, her neck, her lower back. Like, she's taped up everywhere. So it could also be like, it's kind of funny. It's like, it's easy when you're challenging for the title, right? But it's hard to stay on top. Like, Shuri was falling apart coming into the match.
Yeah, she's banged up as can be. She had tape everywhere. And it could be one of those things where she looks in and is like, "Ooh, Tommy, how was your 2022? After your 2021 run, you're not taped up. You look nice and relaxed." She's like, "Yeah, sure." He's got to be like, "You know what? I could use 12 to 13 months of six woman tags where I work 3 minutes. I am beat up."
Yeah,
and she's a little more older than the rest. I mean, she's all the way in her 30s, I think.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how I feel. I don't really like the strong style match. Like when I see them, like, literally, like, full force headbutting and being dropped on their necks onto, like, concrete, I'm like, ugh, I just feel like I want to throw up.
I liked it. And I like to... I don't like legitimate headbutts that I agree with. And I don't like stuff that looks crazy or looks completely dangerous. But two professionals here, I'd like to... everything was stiff as can be. As you could tell at the end when they were bawling their eyes out from the adrenaline dump. But, I mean, there's a point where, I mean, I don't know. It had to be different than every other match, right? And this, like, was the world championship match with a title change. I mean, this had to be a real fight. How else is this match going to get the O?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I guess I liked it because Julia said I did.
What's your thoughts on the show overall?
I think I'd give it a Mina Shirakawa out of a Panan Dimple Point.
Is that a 5, a 7 out of 10?
It was good. Good show. Recommend it.
Oh, dude, it was good. My take is that I think it's worth talking about because this is the end of our first year doing Stardom Fan. And we started this basically because in 2021, we started watching Stardom. And we might have been spoiled. So I watched this show and I'm like, yeah, it was good. However, I mean, I don't know. However, but we are the first year we started watching was with Utami on top and Shuri chasing. So like that, you know, like there's so much. It was almost like we were spoiled. And our first Queendom, like everyone we wanted to win won. Like our first Queendom was a fanboy's dream, to the point where even Azumi lost. All right.
I don't think I hated Azumi then.
No, I didn't. But in retrospect, they knew what we wanted. They knew what we wanted before we knew what we wanted. So it was fantastic. So to go from that high, it's almost like, where do you go from now? You almost have to have a year that's just a little bit down before you can go back up and with Utami.
Well, Julia said I loved it, so that's the answer I'm going to give.
I just wanted to...
I mean, I don't know. Could you... How can you say it's all right? You say all our people didn't win. Like,
well, it's because I'm the type of Mark who doesn't just.
You got to see Akari
for the sake of the wrestling.
You got to see Akari in a singles match.
Oh no, no, that's exactly what I was gonna say. Like the wrestling was awesome, but like,
Mayu,
I'm still a child at heart, where like winners and losers matter.
Mayu gets to play with all her friends. That
true.
Was good. I get the return of the Venus, Mina Shirakawa.
It's fantastic, and her two bimbos.
My Himi is the number one contenders.
Fantastic.
Utami beats Kairi, but, you know, it's a draw, but it was a badass match, and she's probably going to get a title shot out of it.
Wonderful.
As opposed to you thought she was going to lose.
Uh-huh.
We had a garbage hardcore match, but it sets up for Starlight to break out for her singles run of 2023.
Okay.
Meltier loses the tag belts.
This is such a like reversal of your glass being half full and mine being half empty. I'm not used to this, but I like it. So continue.
Saya Kamatani has a match.
Usually I'm trying to talk you off the edge. I swear to God, a month ago, after the fucking tag league, you were like, I don't think I like this anymore. Like, just it's all right. It'll be okay.
Saya Kamatani has the match of the 5-star.
Yeah. With Starlight Kid's friend.
Shuri gets to not die anymore in main events.
Okay.
Because she was being held together by duct tape. And
yes.
We all love, love, love Julia.
Well, that's only because she told you to love, love, love her. Can I...
Oh, well,
just...
you said the glass is half full, and... I hate that phrase so much. It makes no goddamn sense. How can... Is the glass half empty or half full? It depends how... No, asshole, it doesn't depend how you're looking at it. Are you filling a glass up or are you emptying it out? Because if you're emptying a glass out, it's half full when you're emptying it. And if you're filling it up, it's half empty until it reaches the top and then it's full.
I'm so glad you're back. You were like really positive for the last 5 minutes and all of a sudden a glass put you over the edge. I like it. I'd like to raise you everything you just said, which is fantastic. And it makes for a great show. However, Hanan becomes the last year we were spoiled on our first, which also ended up being the first Queendom, which I didn't know at the time. Hanan becomes the Futures champion.
Uh-huh.
My Himi Poi retains.
Uh-huh. That's good.
Starlight Kid beats Koguma and Azumi in one match. God bless her.
Yeah.
We have...
That's pretty cool.
And then we finish up with Shuri beating Utami, which I don't know how that ends up. But, I mean, so anyways.
Skip the rest of the show. I didn't like.
Listen. Like, if I'm trying to look at last year, like, I was ready for Shuri to win. Like, it was fine. Like, we love Utami. But, like, Shuri's build was so good. I was ready for it. Julia's build was so, I don't know, that I was like, you know what? Sure, he can have it another year.
Yeah, the story of women coming back from a neck injury, challenging, getting jealous of her, wanting to break out on her own, kicking her friend, leaves her group, betrays her. Or you could say that, like, dressing up like Murder Momos is kind of like a red flag, and sure, he had to get out of there.
Oh, yeah, and Saya won last year over
No, losing.
See, that was the biggest match. Thank you, Enigma, for helping me out. That was the little pothole I had in my head. How did I miss Saya?
Not only could, think, what a year. She couldn't even, not only could she not beat Shuri at the beginning of the year, she couldn't beat Mayu, had to challenge her friend first, loses, has to battle through the five star, and then she wins on her second try, because if she doesn't win on her second try, who knows when she gets a third try.
It almost feels like Shuri was the underdog all year.
I mean, you say that, but she snapped a lot of arms and kicked a lot of faces.
Yeah, her bad tournament still put a sour taste in my mouth, I think. But I guess it was that. And that's sort of the way I feel about Queendom is sort of the way I feel about the year. Like, it was an awesome year, and it was still my favorite year out of any wrestling that I've watched. And, you know, we watch everything. And Stardom was still the most entertaining year. But I still think the only thing that suffers is that we were spoiled from the first year. The Saya stuff, Saya winning the Cinderella and then being built up to beat Tam, that was big. I mean, this year we had Starlight Kid's friend go for the white belt. What happened to Mariah Cinderella? You know, we don't even get the clap, clap, claps anymore. When New Era comes out, Ami's music plays, for heaven's sakes. Shuri, Julia, that build just, you know what? And it's that, maybe it's not against them. It could have been that Utami Shuri build was maybe one of the best things ever. I mean, that could just be as easy as that.
Okay, but the real question is, when Charlotte Flair comes to Stardom, do they hand her Julia or Kyrie's belt?
I don't know. She can probably take them all for all I care. You know how I feel about that. I would say it on a Stardom fan podcast, but she is pound for pound the best pro wrestler in the world.
Yes.
Anything else on this? Anything else on your mind? Did you want to do a attendance while you have an audience?
You know, to be honest, it's like Queendom is Queendom. It's like my favorite wrestling's biggest show of the year. And I'm like, I feel like obliged to cover it. But I don't know what it is. It's like I hate talking about, I like speculating about wrestling and I love watching it. And I hate talking about it afterwards. But that's probably why I like pro wrestling, because other sports, like this team's the champ, or the new world champions, whatever, Super Bowl champions, and then you gotta wait like a whole like freaking year and hope that your team even makes the playoffs for the first time in 50 years, versus if I don't like a wrestling show, then just watch the show in 2 days from now and they're already moving on to the next thing.
Well, yeah, there's no off-season in wrestling.
Shuri's in an off-season right now.
Yeah, right. She probably wrestled today.
And after Bro Tommy saw Saya chicken out after it's the Futures champion, so congratulations. You just got scared of a rookie. I think she's looking to be the next big free agent. All I've said is I want... How good was Shuri, Utami, and Lady C at the whatever you call it show? Stardom Showcase. That was a
dude,
team.
Either we worked ourselves or I worked myself into the fact that I literally thought there was a chance that the artist champions become Utami, Saya Kamatani, and Lady C. For heaven's sakes. And quite frankly, I thought the greatest team that could be made would be Utami and Lady C. if I can, just because I want to record it, throw it in the podcast, because I think it's important to thank the people that joined us. I'm just going to scroll through real quick. And if I forgot anyone, I'm sorry, but it looks like going back really far, even watching your stream of the game, was Hendrix, Abzel Doba, New Age Weeb, Angelo, who is probably still cuddled up in a starlight blanket, Lizard Master,
Starlight Kid onesie.
He's got it. He's got his own onesie, a mask. Enigma V4 from Talk for Glory. Arangelo. I don't want to miss anybody. Very active today. Everyone's been fun.
I know it's tough to go through a whole chat.
Well, I try to keep up as I go, but I wanted to get through this. I get caught up reading, and then I don't listen to you so much. So it's fun to go back through. There's a lot of good takes.
Yeah, I also like to hear myself talk. Before did a Wrestle Kingdom predictions video, which one's Wrestle Kingdom today? Tomorrow.
Yeah, it's in about 2.5 hours. Don't spoil anything for me. If you see something on the internet you don't like, I'm not watching it till nighttime.
Oh, I can't possibly think I would care.
Well, yeah. I don't know if... I don't think you'd care. I think you'd find something that on Instagram that'll come on your thing that'll annoy you and you'll send it over, not thinking. Oh. When Sasha Banks is the new Stardom champion.
Oh.
New Age Weeb.
She can be the new... New Japan world champion. What do I care? Don't New Japan my Stardom. That's
Chris
all
Mingle.
I gotta say. Chris Mingle.
Mayu could do three eps. Was that when talking about the thing? We haven't.
You missed.
I think we talked about.
You missed Mayu Iwatani is the GOAT.
We
and
talked
Vladek
about doing.
Young.
What's that?
Oh, nothing. Just talking.
I meet the wrestler. We were talking about doing a Mayu Iwatani, but one, her story is sad, I think. But then it gets really happy, obviously, with a happy ending. And two, it would be really long.
I thought it could be fun to start. I don't know what the deal was about their New Year's program they did. It was like a 12-hour thing, and they've uploaded pretty much all of it to their YouTube page, and I thought it could be fun to do watch-alongs for that coming up.
Yeah, watch-alongs on Twitch. I want to do them for our match of the months. What's the worst that's going to happen? Get kicked off Twitch? I doubt it. There's probably wrestling on Twitch right now that's copyrighted. A three-part Mayu story. Wasn't Utami three parts? Mayu would be really long.
It was, but we had to stop at two because there was a whole one part was one match. But it was an important match. Maybe that's what I should do. We should do a play-by-play of this match. Make it a tradition.
No. See, Enigma's got a brain on him. Not only does he know everything about wrestling, but he'll even correct you about your own podcast if you wait long enough.
Well, if he doesn't know, it was originally a 5-part and we had to cut out because we have lives. It's
cool.
Not. It's a story that's still writing itself.
Dude, Tommy, one you're like,
yeah.
You know what? Mayu, someone did the work for us in the Mayu camp. Doesn't she have a movie coming out? We'll transcribe her movie.
Yeah, I applied to be
as a kid
Rossi's understudy, but didn't work out.
No.
They said I was too good looking.
Oh.
They also said I had too much charisma. I'm like, guys. And they said like the budget was too small to pay me what I was deserved.
Is that right?
Yeah. And then I think Mayu said she wanted to go on a date with me. And then I woke up.
That's funny. Did you want to do... I need another break in a second. Did you want to do attendance or anything else you wanted to go over? I'm pretty happy with the way the year ended. It was fun, and we did good. And it is 1-4, the 1-year anniversary of your first Stardom fan YouTube video.
That I can't play on a live stream.
I was going to say, if you play your own video on the live stream, don't you get... Get a strike for doing... Yeah, but you did that with Yu-Gi-Oh! Last time. Ride the Chocobo isn't any strikes, is it?
Of course. What happened? They got rid of the thing to scroll... There used to be a thing where you can scroll down to, like, the oldest videos. They got rid of that?
Oh, I don't know.
I'm wondering, like, what is the oldest video I can play? Probably...
Yeah.
Less, like, I'd probably have to scroll farther than you'd think.
Yeah, I went back like 4 days ever. This was the history of Stardom fan as we watched Queendom last year. And, well, it was right before that, actually. Like, we should do this because...
I don't know.
I don't like the other one Stardom fan or the one Stardom podcast. Well, no, I mean, you're just going through. I thought I was just going to chit-chat, but that's fine. Of course it doesn't matter.
I like Tommy Wins for Grandpa. That's one of my personal favorites.
That's a cute one. I'll be back.
Oedo Tai Dance Party. That's pretty good. I could do it. Mayu's storybook is the size of a dictionary. Yeah, her story... I want to do a Mayu Meet the Wrestler, but it'd be a long one. And it's kind of a bummer before it becomes like a really good story. It's probably why they're making a movie out of it. I'm like, I don't know if I want to be bummed out right now. But that'll have to happen eventually. Ooh, lollipop for artist champs. Wouldn't that be amazing? What is Tam's autobiography called? It's called like the White Manifesto or something. Mayu's book is called something funny. I don't want to go on eBay, but. What the hell is the name of her book title? It's called something like, I was a shut-in loser and now I'm a pro wrestler. But yeah, Queendom was really good. Oh, how do I get some of these news? The cutest bus in the universe, the Stardom bus that travels around the country, has exploded. Mayu Yamatani, the design is too cute. So there's a Stardom tour bus that, oh my god, they did a press conference and a ribbon ceremony for their tour bus they finally got. How the hell were they getting them around the country to begin with?
The Mayu bus?
Yeah, might as well call it the Mayu bus.
Upset it doesn't have a tail.
The Stardom bus, so it'll travel around the country from now on. Maybe it'll appear in your city. That's actually, you wouldn't think a bus would be that expensive. Like, it would take that long to get a bus to, I don't know, get the wrestlers to where they need to be so you could, like, put on a show and, like, make money. Hendrick says the cutest bus in the universe. That's a feud Tam can't win. Imagine being losing a cuteness contest to a bus.
Her face not being on it is funny.
Surprised Mayu's. I'm surprised it's not just a big, what are they, like those stickers that people put on like the back window of their truck. They don't just have Kyrie's face plastered over every window. Kyrie's face, and then underneath, like, every picture they've ever taken of her, it's just like a tour date. I loaded up Fire Pro again. I'm like, I wonder if I actually have any Stardom wrestlers. Cause like,
you might as well.
It's a lot more fun to.
I think you can download them, or they have a Stardom pack, but that's old. It's probably not even up to date anymore. And it's probably expensive.
Probably. I forgot how to make. Apparently, at one point, I knew how to make wrestlers because I have all sorts of lists of wrestlers, but. Now I have a Stardom page. I'm like, oh, apparently I thought that was a good idea at one point with no wrestlers on it. My boy Cody Rhodes.
The funnest part about this game is downloading the fan-made wrestlers.
Well, that's a project. For sure. Ooh, Mayu ice cream bars. What do you think a Mayu flavored ice cream bar would taste like? I'm guessing it would be like the mystery flavor on like those like lollipops.
It tastes like icons.
Yeah, it tastes like, I don't know. Ever just say stuff and you have to like, don't say that out loud.
Cake flavor. With, well, there's still some people here. I think the upcoming, our schedule should be pretty fun. We'll do our award show as a live stream. And that, there's no reason that can't be in January, right?
Whoa.
I mean, there's really nothing else going on, but this, we'll be talking about the start of Triangle Derby. Other than that, we'll be able to give away our shimmies.
Well,
so that'll be on a live stream.
I got huge news. Coming late February, they're coming out with the Stardom Winter Blanket Collection so that you can sleep with all your favorite Stardom girls. Mayu Iwatani, Hazuki, Utami, Saya, Azumi, Saki, Kashima, Starlight Kid, Julia, Micah, Himika, Tam Nakano, Mina Shirakawa, Natsu Poit, and Shuri. Let your favorite player warm you up in various situations, such at home, in the office, at the venue, anywhere you please. I like how I just do ads for them sometimes. And they ban all my videos every time a person actually looks at them. Hello?
Hello.
Half of their news are just like new merch that they're selling. Yeah, we got to start up. I guess we could start now. If you guys check, make sure you. I don't know how you can see. I wish YouTube was better at showing the community page, but if you search up the channel, there's like a tab for community page, and we'll start uploading our categories, our nominees for our award show that you can start voting on pretty soon.
Yeah, it'd be good to. That's a good idea, because then. Yeah, and in a couple weeks at least, there's no reason not to to do the show. And I'm thinking, being a first year, that's when it makes sense to finally do the fan appreciation giveaway. I went out of my way to get a whole brand new PWI 150 only because it had the Stardom girls on it, but I bought an extra one. I was going to give it away to a lucky Stardom fan. You know, probably not that night. Well, it'll be a ballot thing because I think I want the podcast fans to get a shot at the people that listen to the podcast a shot too. But if you're joining the live stream, of course, like you get like an extra, what would you say, an extra tally or an extra chance to win. And then, well, I don't know, we'll do a live stream and a random number generator and see who's the winner.
Yeah. And
assuming not, I'm sure that, I'm sure Enigma probably already bought his, but is his signed by one half of the Stardom fans? Or probably not.
And you can, I'll also be throwing in a Ariake Arena crossover. I happened to catch someone reached out to me and they sent me the air guitar pick that Tanahashi was using. And I'll sign it and everything.
Not the air guitar pick. Oh, that's awesome. I know New Age bought one too. Who else other we can't be the only ones who it was the first time we've ever bought in a PWI magazine, and it was only because they finally have the best pound for pound pro wrestlers in the world on the cover.
Yeah. So there's still some people in the chat. Someone's got to figure out they were selling a Santa Mayu Iwatani portrait at Corkin Hall. I need this in my life. How does one obtain this?
I bet you Enigma has four of them and Weeb has two of them, so maybe one of them has an extra.
It says Santa Iwatani's cute cat-eared Santa figure. Santa Iwatani is coming to your house. Why don't you spend the best Christmas with Santa Iwatani? Please buy it at the venue. I'm like, I wish.
Enigma called you out. Didn't you also have a Tanahashi air guitar? Yeah, but you were trying to like bogart that and keep it for yourself. That was going to be part of the giveaway, and then you're keeping it.
Damn.
Now you got to give away your Utami air guitar and your Tana air guitar and the picks.
Well, as you know, people reached out to us. Like, you have the only official Utami air guitar. I have the Tanahashi air guitar. And then a couple weeks back, someone reached out and said, hey, I found the pick. It was like a janitor while he was sweeping up the venue. Like some J-pop band. I wonder what the first news story is. Like 139 pages. When did they start their news?
Yeah, I'm more curious of what the first year or the... Yeah, I was going to say, I thought it goes back all the way. I was actually curious when they started tracking it on this website.
Iwatani in a match and Marvelous.
Versus Alvin?
Uh-huh. And the Chipmunks. And then the first actual Stardom news was a report for a 5-star show. That's cool.
It's funny what a few years make. If you go back up with everyone on there, some of those girls, I mean, well, they are. I mean, what, 4 or 5 years? 4 or 5 years. Fucking super young.
Yeah, Starlight was still a kid.
She hasn't grown into her mask yet.
No.
I was all excited during the Oedo Tai match, she finally came out with spikes in her mask, but then she took it off. It's like it was no holds barred.
Ooh.
Careful on the Twitter. There's a show you don't want spoiled.
What show?
They had a show today. Or yesterday. It was the start of the Triangle Derby.
Yeah, but I want to read about a bus. It's fascinating that Stardom just having a bus, like a travel bus, is like newsworthy.
Well, didn't Komomo walk to one of the events? I mean, it takes a while.
Yeah. That was a thing. And Komomo came into Stardom. She's like, hey guys, I'm just going to walk to the next venue. And then it was 8 hours till, or whatever, 12 hours when the next show was supposed to be. And then she posted, Google Maps of her. I was like, oh, it was going to take like 3 days to walk there. But sometimes you get good spoilers. Like, who doesn't love more G.I. Sakurai? Come on.
Yeah, that's a highlight.
I feel like Julia should shave her head again.
They were teasing that at a point during the year when her and Tam went up against each other. They're like, Tam would be like, another hair match. And Julia's like, no more hair match. No. Oh, dear God.
This hair system that she had at the time is like, you know how hard this is to maintain.
That was super cool, though. I liked every bit of that. G.I. Julia was good stuff. And it was even funny, too, because if you remember, like, the first time she came out afterwards, she came out with a baseball cap, and then she was all embarrassed taking it off.
Yeah, and then she murdered Gokien. And she murdered Gokien. That was the best.
I forgot Hogan came out with the air guitar. Was it an air guitar or was he playing his boa? Or his that feather thingy, a feather boa.
Oh,
that's funny, Lizard Master. Komomo's brain is chicken?
Well, that's the name of a video. Oh, that's what's going to be on there. Starlight Kid runs over prominence on a bicycle.
So is there a chance that Julia kept My Himi around just because they're the only two that are strong enough to lift her up on their shoulders to carry her out like she deserves?
Thecla's boulder like shoulders.
You know what? This is the type of spot that I would usually find annoying, but it was actually, like, so perfect because the other girls, like, actually held them down. Because usually, you know, when wrestling does a spot like this, it's like, oh, no, the bike's coming. What do I do? Not move. But it actually shows her teammates holding the other girls down so they can't move. This was fantastic.
Holding them down.
Yeah, they're holding them down right there. There they go. Oh, that last girl got it right over the neck. I love it. Oh, that went south quick.
I like. That's all you love, Starlight.
The funny part is that bike weighs more than her.
It does. I like how she can hit. I can actually like
zoom in that poor girl's back.
What? Yeah. What? Why? Why do you do this to yourself?
She is in a lot of shitty matches.
Like, you could look like this.
Yeah. I like, if you're going to do all those shitty matches, I don't know, wear a shirt. that doesn't get cut by light tubes.
I always joke about Risa Sarah, like, she got this arm thing. I'm like, oh, she probably has, like, third-degree burns from some, like, garbage match she did in a parking lot.
That's probably too, because her body's even more fucking shredded up.
I'm going to love that we're, like, body-shaming them, and it turns out they just, like, I have eczema.
No, we're not body-shaming them. I feel bad for them. Like, you don't have to do that to yourself. You're actually good wrestlers. You don't have to do garbage matches.
Yeah, but the real question is, like, what is this tattoo?
The Kashima tattoo? You've almost pieced it all together. A little bit here, a little bit there. And how far does it go?
All the way up or down. I don't know where it starts. Ding, ding, ding. You ever wonder, like, maybe the reason, like, people in Japan just sit on the floor is because they keep, like, breaking all the furniture?
We actually had a whole three-part series on, we were spitballing a new Meet the Tattoo series. We were trying to figure out the guy.
Look, oh, you can, it's, there you go. You get his little peek, little whoop, there it is.
A little peekaboo. It's like the Mayu shorts. Just a little peekaboo.
Like, what is it? I need to know. Oh.
And the funny part is her bikini megs cover it up even more.
I think that looks like a little barbed wire. Ooh, a new side of sake.
You just taught New Age Weeb something. Well, if you watch wrestling by a lot of freeze framing, you learn a lot more, apparently.
What?
New Age Weeb says if that was part of the game. I'm like, well, if you do as much freeze framing as Juno does while watching the show, you'll learn a lot about the girls.
Oh, my favorite thing to do sometimes.
Freeze frame and zoom. Oh.
Yeah, exactly. On the phone, you can zoom on YouTube now.
Really? Is it a pinch thing?
Yeah.
Like the pinch pull action? Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
Besides just, like, you know, recording something and then taking it into my thing and... a lot of their stuff isn't on YouTube where I could just do the playback speed, but I like watching on Stardom World and I want to see if, like, something was really, like, brutal. So I'll do one of these. Huh? Oh, like this! This was brutal! I'll just do like
frame at a time. Yeah.
Yeah.
See, the worst part about that is she hits like the edge.
I'm trying to get it perfect. All right, let's see.
Shit.
Oh, look, that arm doesn't bend that way.
Garbage cans what took Kenta out for, I don't know, way too long. It almost killed him. Well, that and a 12-foot ladder. And a Tanahashi. I like Listen Master. He's got to be closer to my age. He's all in on the fucking WCW, Hogan, and NWO.
Yeah, I guess he did. He was doing the air guitar. He probably got it. I don't know.
It's fucking great.
He probably stole it from
He was playing the belt a lot, too. Yeah, I'm sure. I'd like to see a Tana versus Hogan.
What? Some... I want to be this guy. How do you get...
When you're 30 years old... No, so when you're like... That puts this guy at the prime of his wrestling life. What are you, 10 or 12 when the NWO's big? Oh, man. How good is that wrestling?
Oh, I think I see. I think she bounced her off the mat. Oh.
Did they show the Kashima spot where she got landed the Kishikasi and they broke it up? I thought the Kishikasi was going to win.
Yeah, oh, I was trying to figure out where this is the first thing they did. I was trying to figure out, you're like, oh, they didn't use thumbtacks or nothing. I'm like, no, they just decided to dump a bunch of shit all over the ring and then never do anything with it.
No, it's good because it sucked and it was stupid. So they learned the baseball bat spot was one of my favorite things. She lost her baseball bat, so she got a better baseball bat.
Suzu,
I love this Momo.
Suzu dumps a bunch of like toys from the dentist's office on Starlight. Oh, and then the ref has to fucking spend 20 minutes wiping it off. Like, why don't they give him a broom? You ever notice when they have to wipe something out of the ring, they just have to kick it?
Abzo has the exact opposite reaction to me. Every time Kashima gets hit, I'm like, she's so fragile, leave her alone. I'm like, I don't want to see her get body slammed. Every time, like after that suplex, I'm like, just please stand back up. She's so fucking good.
This will never get old.
Back to the bicycle.
Ring, ring, ring.
She's such a fucking goofball, ain't she? The back tire over the fucking neck of that last girl just makes me...
Yeah.
I can't get enough of it.
Playback. Oh.
I was like, that hurts so fucking bad.
Yeah. Oh my god, she's done that. She's aerial right now.
I can't believe Starlight didn't like eat shit on the whole thing, as funny as that is.
She looks terrible. Yeah, that's a face of pure fear.
She thought there's a second there where she thought she was going into the front row.
Also, here, when the back tire, it just comes like Momo's holding her head perfectly so that the back tire can just decapitate this other.
Oh, ideally it was supposed to be back. Yeah, but then
that's airborne. Right off
Suzu.
It's
funny. it's so funny. It's funny because, well, even without watching this, when we watched it live, I was like, oh my god, that looked like it killed that girl.
The more time. The front wheel completely kills Suzu. The back wheel hits her in the same spot, right? The front wheel
and hits. Then she does a little ollie right over Risa Sarah.
Yeah, she completely unscathed. What?
We've caught that too. Completely misses Risa Sarah. That's fucking funny. Oh, it basically does. It basically does go right over her. That's funny.
That is so good. Presento. And then how'd she... Oh, they just skipped in the match. I'm like, how'd she get up so fast? With YouTube, it's like... I can just do everything in, like, quarter speed. It's so cool.
Did their, did they end up posting the chair spot that was missed on Stardom World?
Oh.
When they set up all the furniture, and then they were showing something in the ring that didn't matter, and all of a sudden you heard 45 chairs crash?
Probably not.
Because it's fucking hilarious. I almost hope they... don't have that angle. The fact that they missed the biggest spot of the entire thing is actually why I love Japanese professional wrestling so much. They film it like a sport. It's like sometimes you just miss what happens.
Oh, not like this. Oh, Suzu gets fucked here. Oh, why? I didn't realize the trash can was already dented to begin with. This is, like, changing my world right now. Like, these clips on YouTube that I can slow down.
Yeah, I didn't know you could do that. That's pretty fun.
Oh, you could also speed it up. Which I think... Oh, this would be hilarious. This might be funny.
Oh, you loved that at the time. That was one of your favorite things. You're like, that is awesome! A lifeless Saki being thrown out for the pin.
Yeah.
Yeah, the chair spot was the finish, and they missed it. Yeah, it was basically the reason the entire team was out of commission. Yo, Lizard, Juno, that's closer to your age. Lizard Master, first match he ever watched was Kane's debut at Bad Blood In Your House 97. That's not a bad first match to ever watch as a kid getting into wrestling, I'll tell you that much. And how'd you get your parents to buy a pay-per-view for the first match ever? He must have had a parent that was a wrestling fan.
My first ever time watching wrestling, I just flipped on the TV, and it just happened to be on like SmackDown and when Kane took his mask off.
So you watched the bad Kane stuff.
No, like, I like that Kane. He'd come out with that. He would be, like, handcuffed, and he'd come out with, like, 8 cops.
Well, of course you like that Kane. That's your Kane. Never forget your first.
And then he was basically the RK bro. And you team with Rob Van Dam. Alright, there's only so many times I can watch.
I want to know what everyone's first wrestling match is now.
I don't know about
all
my first.
I remember is Ultimate Warrior. I don't remember a first match. I remember moments. I remember the Ultimate Warrior.
I was
a child of the 80s, so I remember the Ultimate Warrior running out. This in slow motion is awesome.
Oh! was that Lizard Master? Someone said they love watching Saki get dropped on her head.
Oh, it terrifies me.
That's the first bump she took in 3 months.
That was a bad one, too. I mean, it was a good one, but it was brutal.
How come this one doesn't have scars all over her back? Or maybe she does. She's wearing a shirt. Or maybe that's why
she's
she doesn't have
dumb.
Scars
she's
on her back.
Mother.
Maybe that's why she doesn't have scars all over her back. She's like, you know, I'm going to wear a shirt.
On the recap of this match, they didn't even do the chair spot, huh?
The end of Stardom videos ends with Miyu.
Finger bang?
Wanna finger bang bang. Oh no. That music is deaf.
Hendrix has a good one. My first memory of wrestling is when I was searching for Monster by Imagine Dragons to listen to and accidentally stumbled into Daniel Bryan's WrestleMania 30 promo. Fantastic.
How? Oh, because he's like...
I was going to say, why don't you put that and search that up, but putting on a WWE video will probably be in...
The tag... Take you right I was thinking, how does that relate? And I'm like, someone was probably in the tags, but like, wasn't he like the dragon or something in Ring of Honor? It's probably like a YouTube tag.
Well, he's Red Dragon, yeah, so maybe it's something like that. That's funny.
Daniel.
Or American Dragon, right? Or something like that. Or he was Team Red Dragon. That's fucking cool, though.
WrestleMania 30 after what? Oh, I'll just put in promo. Apparently, it's a big thing. Is that when it was like People Power or something?
Was that the Yes Movement?
Yeah. I don't know what it is though, because like, it's one of those things that's just been edited because it's such a like cool moment. It's like I just want to find like the original thing.
I know, but you can't. You have to go on Peacock and find the thing. Like WWE has WWE is the only entity that has the entire internet scrubbed where you can't get anything proper.
Right. That's like I'm trying to think. I don't remember.
New Age Weep. My first match was Edge versus Lita in the bed in the middle of the ring.
Dude, the best part about that.
That's what I tell you. That's
the highest
that's the
rated.
Shit where people...
The highest rated segment on Raw ever.
I swear to God, you're like that era just gave wrestling the bad name because that was that's where the whole thing where no wrestling isn't all TNA and then like every time someone walks into like the room to see what you're watching it's like mom no it's not that they were just wrestling I don't know what the beds of the ring for.
Oh yeah, did you know?
Oh shit, that's funny.
Did you know like that had to be scrubbed from the internet because apparently they couldn't just pretend
with the bed
like apparently like they were making Lita actually take her clothes off because like you can see your titty in like on like the live Raw.
Jesus. Well, I don't know.
Which
it's
is
so funny.
Insane. No, the best part about that segment of Raw is like and we're gonna celebrate right in the center of the ring. And then you're thinking like, okay, so something's gotta happen, right? Like this can't be real. And then Ric Flair comes out, like 85-year-old Ric Flair, and he's like, I'll show you how to move.
Oh no.
And he's
I'm not sure that flies in 2022.
In 2022. Kurt Angle. My first wrestling is Kurt Angle lock to someone.
I know, sometimes you just remember bits and pieces. My first wrestling show, all I remember is it was at a small place in my hometown, and I saw Doink the Clown. Like, I've looked up the playbill since, but the only thing like that stands out in my memory is Doink the Clown versus Shawn Michaels. That happened.
The eighth Doink. Like, I love how for a character that was so, like, unimportant, there was 85 Doink the Clowns. Like, they felt, no, we need to have a Doink.
Yo, that shit was when wrestling was still, that was before the Attitude era, when wrestling was fun and goofy. And there was
Isaac Yankum.
Yeah, everyone had a profession. We had Duke the Dumpster. We had Repo Man. We had the Dentist, you know?
How come all these, how come all these wrestlers need a second profession?
Well, it's like anyone who's not in one of the big three sports. Like, if you're a lacrosse player, chances are you're still a doctor or something on the, you know, you have a real job.
Well, that's what confused me. It's like, why do all these wrestlers need
a baseball player, right in, if no, the thing was still here, his hometown, the Brooklyn Brawler.
But that was so confusing. Like, number one, why do these wrestlers need second professions? And number two, some of them, it's like, I feel like you'd make more being a dentist.
Oh, the hockey player? We had the Mountie? No. Well,
the Mountie.
They were Mounties.
Yeah.
They were Mounties.
The Bushwhackers.
Oh, my goodness.
They do whatever Bushwhackers do. That's like a profession.
Well, the original even they were like the original... before they started licking people when they were sheep herders, they were like the original Briscoe brothers of today. Just like badass farmers.
Roddy Piper was a talk show host.
Yeah. Well done. Mr. Perfect was a pitcher, a baseball player, a basketball player.
He threw a touchdown pass to himself.
Yeah, he did. I have the commercial to prove it.
On his first time ever throwing a football.
Those old Mr. Perfects were like the best commercials.
You know that actually happened? Just say that. It's like that actually happened in real life because everyone's like, oh, you just throw a touchdown pass to yourself. Like,
IRS, that's right. We had tax collectors. Jesus Christ, that was a funny time.
Like, in like a, how was it? I don't know. Marcus Mariota.
The Dean?
I don't know.
It was like a literal Dean of college. I can't remember who it was, though. It was the Dean something. It was a favorite.
It's probably like a dog funny. Catcher, right?
The professions is so funny because they were all like the third tier wrestlers, right? Because none of them were like holding belts and shit, right?
I can finally
then you just had like the Hogans and the Bret Harts and stuff.
I can finally figure out how the Kishikashi works. All right, and quarter speed. Let's see, it might be too quick still.
It's the Kishikashi is magic. People have all even right? tried to Kishikashi her, and she's
okay.
got the key. She
starts
out.
In a suplex. How does this turn into a Kishikashi?
Gold Dust the pervert.
Okay, she... Okay. Takes the arm. Just shoves him down. I thought it was more like... what did you say? Complicated than that?
I'll tell you what, watching that in slow motion shows how good Sakurai's like facials are. Like, as soon as she gets wrapped up, she's like, oh no!
Oh, that's fucking great. Oh, I didn't even bother to check, like,
faces are the best part of wrestling. Yeah, watch her. As soon as she starts getting wrapped up, she knows she's fucked.
No!
It's fucking amazing. It's great.
And then after, her face after is really good. Wait, complains to the ref here. What is... Thekla's in her own world. Yeah, her face is really good. Like, what, that was it? Three? Starlight's like, yeah, it was.
That's why I tell you, fucking 95% of Stardom's a shoot, man. Look at how real she looks. She's like, she's pissed. She can't believe it.
Goldust, the pervert. All right, well,
did we say Duke the Dumpster? I think we probably did. Duke the Dumpster Drossy.
I'm surprised the second most popular video is Natsupoi versus Hazuki.
Well, Hazuki's pretty cool.
Ooh. Mayu. Oh. If this is... Some of these videos I remember, like, when Hana, Kimura, and Julia were in a feud, like, I just remember, if this is the clip I'm thinking of, they've gotten a fight backstage, and they were knocking, like, stuff off of, like, tables and whatever, and there was a bag that, like, a gym bag that just had all the titles shoved in. I don't know.
Oh, shit! I don't know why that just refreshed my memory. Julia and Hazuki at the beginning of the year had a whole bunch of heat. Does this just mean that Hazuki's going to get a red belt chance this year? Right? It's got to happen. Well, Hazuki's our next red belt champion. They're building. They're building it. It started at the beginning of this past year.
That is a tongue twister. Say Kishikashi Tanahashi 5 times. Remember when Tanahashi and a hot dog were doing a promo with the Cosmic Angels?
Hanma confuses the fuck out of me. He's like fucking 75 years old. He's got the body of a 20-year-old and the voice of a 300-year-old.
No, go back to Hanma. I don't care about the Cosmic Angel.
He's a fucking freak.
It's insane.
Yo, all these girls' ages combined don't even equal his age.
Right? Oh, I was wrong. She figured out how to do the under boob. That's impressive. Damn it.
Which is, and that's why she's going to get kicked out of the Cosmic Angels.
Like,
those two girls standing right next to her is why she's teamed up with Natsupoi. Because you can't tell who the star is, but when Tam is next to Natsupoi, you can figure out the star.
Okay, one thing I'm very confused about is I feel like I've watched this video before, and they're in bathing suits, and I'm assuming that's a pool. That just there's no reason for it. I don't think they ever used the pool.
No, but if you're not outside a pool, then you have no reason to be in a bathing suit.
Of course you do, because you're Tam Nakano.
Tanahashi didn't know where to look. He's like, look her in the eyes, look her in the eyes, look her in the eyes, look her in the eyes.
No, if you track them, they're kind of down a little bit. So it's like,
well, she's short.
It's like straight past Tam, like right.
Down to Unagi.
Yeah. No, I was gonna.
Obviously.
When they were doing the promo for the five star, not the five star, Jesus, the crossover, and they did the press conference. I just thought of this because Tanahashi in the bathing suit. They were talking about what makes, like, Stardom. Like, what does Stardom bring to the...
How do I clip that? Hold on a second.
What does Stardom bring to the table versus what does New Japan bring to the table? And Tanahashi, just is hilarious, standing next... Who's he next to? Starlight and Mayu, and just, like, dead serious. Like, well, I think the benefit of New Japan is that, like, we're really sexy. So I think I'm going to be in, like, the best shape of my life.
I like that, and I just like that my new favorite drop is going to be, well, Tanahashi in a bathing suit is what jogged my memory. Yeah. Tam Nakano alongside
Jesus
Mina and
Christ.
Unagi.
Look at
that was short-lived.
Right. Look at this meat paw. Jesus. It's barely, it's like, can you even call that a hand scientifically? It's like a hoof.
Dudes are huge, man.
It's a hoof.
Watch out for Great Okan. Great Okan, a fucking creep. The Great Okada, New Japan Pro Wrestling.
I was like, wait.
He's so funny. He doesn't even pretend. He's like, yeah.
I was like,
get over here, women. It's so funny.
And whatever weird attics or / basement they're in, I was like thinking, I thought these were windows. And I'm like, oh, let me look if like Okan's back there somewhere.
I'll be back in a sec.
Damn it. Every time I unmute, there's like a song, and I'm like, it's probably all copyright. Every time. Stardom, Wonder Ring. They're the winners, guys. I clicked on this for Hanma, I promise. I don't remember why. There was a reason. I think it was because the fact that he's 85 years old and he looks jacked as I don't understand his body. They said Tam's muscles have muscles. I'm like, Tam has muscles? How do I get this guy's job? It's like they never stop playing music. That's annoying. Well, I think I clicked because of I clicked for Tam and I stayed for Tana. Let's be honest. Like, is Hanma? I can't tell if he's like flexing all his muscles or if he's just naturally this jacked. Like, it doesn't look normal. Oh, he's definitely flexing. Whoa, dream time. Hiroshi. Damn. Hiroshi. Unagi. Hiroshi. Oh. That wasn't Hiroshi.
Tam is hilarious. She's like, if I literally take my top off, will you guys look at me instead of them?
I'm going to recreate this just for you. I was like, dream time. Just Unagi. Hiroshi. Tam. Hiroshi. Unagi.
Hanma to be the
Hiroshi.
The star of this fucking show.
Oh, you missed the best part. As I was like, it was following a pattern. I was like, ready? I was like, Hiroshi. Unagi. Hiroshi. Oh. That's not Hiroshi. This fucking jacked lunatic.
Kokeshi!
Kokeshi!
What's the next stage? My goodness. What else are they going to do?
I was wondering.
Everything to try to get him to look at him.
I was kind of wondering if like Hanma and Tanahashi were in the photo book with them.
I was going to say, next time you buy a photo book and like fucking the centerfold's Hanma, I don't even know if I'd be mad. Oh my god.
You know,
have you seen him wrestle? Like, do you want, because he's usually at opening matches. If you've never seen him wrestle, he's hilarious. Like, he gets around almost as good as Matt Hardy. Like, he's just fucking, he's a fucking wreck. It's amazing.
Damn it. Look at little baby DDM over here. What was this video? From August 19th, 2020. Himika even has normal posture. You know what I don't understand? Like, these camera angles are weird. How can... First of all, I thought Himika was like... Besides Lady C, like, huge compared to the rest of them. But she's, like, the same height. She looks like she's the same height as Micah. More importantly, how are they all taller than Liger?
Liger is a junior heavyweight.
This is how you train to be a wrestler?
do 200 squats.
I'm trying to find, let me find the one. Oh, this is right here. There's the one exercise they were doing. I thought, yeah, this one. I thought it was a rib. I'm like, there's no way this helps you be a, yeah.
Oh.
I'm like.
And then I tried doing one, and you're like, oh my god, my everything hurts.
No, and then I played the New Japan video game, and I saw Okada doing them.
Was it just as sexy?
No. Why? Well, here's a question.
How about when Liger does it?
Yeah, why is Liger the one wearing the yoga pants?
Oh, dear God.
He's sick. You don't want to blow out your anus. I think that's what that means. Very important safety tip. But how does this help you be a wrestler? I've never seen a wrestler do this in a match.
You gotta stay flexible and keep your core strong. That way you don't.
This is how you kick out of pins.
Get injured. He's awesome, Fender. Drop the mic. Well done.
She's just yelling.
Winding down. You got one more Fire Pro in you? Are you having fun doing this? Hey, you could stay out all night. I just gotta call it quits in a couple.
Yeah, I'm learning how to stomp a mud hole.
Yeah.
This is a good My Pillow ad.
Yeah, I clipped a. I gotta figure out how. There's gotta be an easy way to do it on the PS5 because I'm new to it. I clipped a part of Final Fantasy VII where I'm talking to an NPC and he's all talking about this pillow he sells, and I swear to God, it's a entire sketch about making fun of the My Pillow guy. It's fucking hilarious. It's like My Pillow's the best pillow ever. I didn't have a pillow, but if you buy My Pillow, you get the best night's sleep. I'm like, oh my God.
From Final Fantasy what?
In the Final Fantasy VII remake I'm playing. They're like making. Oh my God, the game's so fucking good. You know what? The first time on the PS4 when it first came out, I played the game through, or most of the way through. I didn't finish it because I just don't finish games, I guess. And I've almost played it as a chore. I'm like, man, I love Final Fantasy, so I'm just going to play this. But this time, like playing the upgraded version, like I'm just sitting there enjoying it. And I'm learning the battle system. It is a good effing game. And then I really want to get into that Persona, to tell you the truth. But I think I might play Final Fantasy 15 after this, because I think 16 might be coming out this year. And then this Final Fantasy Crisis Core that just came out. Oh, I gotta catch up.
So you watched Utami cook chicken for about an hour when we did research for the Meet the Wrestler. How long could you watch her eat steak?
I don't know. According to your unagi slurp and noodles video, they can keep that on repeat for hours.
This is basically the Big Daddy show, if anyone was wondering.
Oh, is that Big Daddy right there?
Oh, yeah. Like, you were explaining to me what the Big Daddy show was about, and I thought you were such a loser. Because you were like, and then I was watching like Utami and her sisters like prep chicken for 45 minutes. And then I was like,
I told you, it's you can't stop watching it.
It sounds so retarded until you watch it. It's like, why am I watching this?
You've been called out by name.
It's not a fantasy I had before. That almost should go on the website.
That's so weird. It's not replaced with the rose. That stays forever. Unless I can get it, unless you, we can gif Big Daddy giving us a rose.
No, that goes. I think that comment should go in the Hall of Fame.
Oh, Juno wishes you were the snake. Okay. Oh yeah, I'll clip it.
I was clipping
all the other things.
Hall of Shame at this point.
No, I like to put this stuff up where people say we're good. And out of context, just someone saying someone wishes you wish you were the snake. That's pretty good shit.
If I go on, if I ever wrote
that's a good sidebar right there.
That's like a quote I would put on a book if I had an autobiography.
Oh, you know what you should do? I don't know if it'll play good. You should go on the GIFs. I put up like a dozen new GIFs. I was bored when I wasn't allowed to sleep for 2 days.
Somehow this is, by the way, this video of her eating like steak is titled Road to Champion. This is how she became Red Belt Champion.
You can't be a champion unless you have the right amount of protein.
Yes.
Hi.
Well, you know, I always got the Stardom fan page up. There's new gifts.
I don't want to gloss over. You can see the if you go back to the main page on the podcast, you can see the
there's new gifts. Oh,
well, it should have been. Maybe they'll load
the Kuma ref. Is that a new one?
Nah, you've seen that one. The Cheers is new.
Oh,
the Unagi Cheers. Entrance is new. Oh, the Starlight, which I labeled what did I say? Melina who.
The Cheers, that is good.
Yeah. Yeah, the Cheers, that's a good gif.
No, the gifs are good. Someone commented that's how they found us before from Google Images. Is this new? It's not, it should be.
Yeah, I had a couple of the old ones I never uploaded before for some reason.
I do gotta update this. Problem with the spreadsheet is it takes like all my time. I do kind of want to, I don't know, like, do I give up on last year's and just like commit to this year's spreadsheet?
Well, there is one show so far.
Yeah, because like the problem is I'm like, I can wait, because you know they'll do like 3 shows a week, and usually it's on like a Friday and like a Sunday. I'm like, all right, I'll wait for those shows to come out. And then by the time it's like you miss 1 week and all of a sudden you're like 6 shows behind. That's like when people cancel on do you realize when people cancel on D&D twice?
Oh, I did the Moneyball gif.
When people cancel D&D on you twice, that's a whole month you're going without playing. Isn't that crazy?
That's why I changed my game to weekly. So when we cancel, it's
no. If you cancel,
not as bad.
You play, right? And then you're supposed to play in a week. People cancel. You're supposed to play the week after. People cancel. I guess it's 3 weeks. But the Kishikashi of the century.
I had to put a Kishikashi on Julia. The way I see it, Saki Kashima has a red belt chance thanks to that clip right there. Is the proof.
I hope she beats everybody. This one looks new. Oh, that's really tiny.
That's funny.
We got a tam cutter.
That must have been the actual resolution I did it at.
No, I've seen that one before.
All right. Well, it's not a perfect science.
Those are good. Those are a couple new gifts. I like it. Unless it scrolls down more.
Yeah, I like those Oedo Tai ones. Those Oedo Tai, I know now they're loaded. Those Oedo Tai entrances. Where I think no. Yeah, that slaps a goodie. Apparently, I have a thing for just Julia getting her ass kicked.
Julia getting slapped. How about Just Bring It?
Yeah, how good is that?
Who was she calling out? I forget, like Mayu or something, right? Or Utami? I think it was Utami. Like her first match.
So fucking good.
Oh, Utami, there's got to be something better to close out on. Although, Utami eating steak somehow was entertaining.
Do a singles match. Did you have Fire Pro wrestlers?
Do I have Fire Pro wrestlers?
Well, you did that Fire Pro. Do a fun singles match.
That could be fun. I don't know if Stardom... Oh, wait. Oh, I can't be... Now I gotta wait for it to load before I can close it. Oh, I forget how to get to the Steam Workshop. I can download two Stardom guys real quick, right? Probably.
Probably.
Do you remember how?
I haven't loaded this game up in so long.
I don't know how to get to anything in the... I don't know how to get to the community page of any game. Like, I search it up in the library. Then I'm like, okay, well then where do I go? It's not in the community. Oh, workshop. Well, there we go. Why would searching up the game bring up the game? Stardom. All right. Wrestlers?
There's 16,000 wrestlers out of Japan. Well, I guess this is... they have the belts and everything. Oh, that's pretty neat.
Right now it's on everything. How do I find... Referee?
Well, there's things on the side.
Wait, where was that? Referee?
We can do female, I think, is a thing on there.
Hey, they got my guy Daichi. Okay. Oh, wait, pro wrestler.
There's no... Well, that's because you have the... Yeah, the referee title.
All right, let's see.
Ooh, hey, Konami. There's a lady! Lady sees number one!
But some of these, I can't... I feel like I've tried to download a bunch of them, and a lot of them use, like, the DLC I don't have.
Oh, for the outfits?
For, like, the move... I don't know.
Yeah, the movesets or something. That makes sense.
All right, well, that's a good match. Well, I gotta find.
I just think it's
Tommy.
Oh, she was up.
But that's like I want.
Oh, that's original outfit, Utami, in that red.
I want like kick ass. Like, oh, here we go. Here we go. This is the Utami we want, right? Oh, it's got all the outfits.
Oh, that's a new outfit.
See, you need the DLC, which is
maybe
there's a thing. There's gotta be a tag like no DLC. Maybe it'll tell me.
Apparently, yeah, I'll tell you to fucking pony up.
Pony up the fucking money. How about? We relive the best match of 2021. Do you need DLC for all of them? All of them.
Yeah, it must be a moveset thing.
Come on. All right, let's...
Do you have them on the... Or does that work? I say, do you have them on the WWE game?
Yeah, but... The problem is you can't play the WWE game. I've tried.
Oh.
All right, well, you know, by process of elimination, hey, Scarlett, there's got to one of...
Oh, you know what? It's funny. Scarlett was in the news recently because I guess I'm a fan, like, threw something at her. And then I heard in the same thing that she was in... She actually wrestled in Stardom. I gotta look that up because Karrion Kross and Scarlett is one of my favorite acts. I'm like, I want to see Scarlett actually wrestle.
It doesn't even tell
look
me.
Look that up. End on that then. And look up Scarlett on fucking New Japan World.
Since you need DLC, what DLC do I need? I need all this DLC.
Just buy the DLC.
I need an $8 entrance pack.
Yeah, yeah, obviously.
I need...
At this point, it's not a fan-created thing anymore.
Well, now they're all on sale for 60% off.
Is it really? Yeah, but there's a ton of them. I was going to say, like, how much is, like, buy everything?
For some reason, there's the New Japan pack.
One of them was actually a donation thing.
Apparently.
That was pretty nice.
Yeah. What am I supposed to... Someone's throwing stuff at who? Hanan. Oh. All right, I got Hanan. Found a... Okay, Hanan. Apparently, I don't need DLC for that one.
All right, so the first two people that don't need DLC fight each other.
And Saki Kashima. Apparently, I already have them. What's so... I don't know how this works. Oh, no, don't open WWE. Well, that's a mistake. No. That crashed the stream, actually.
It will?
It did. I couldn't get a singles match to work properly, and it took like forever to load. And for some reason, it was like five times this. It was like a glitch where everything was like five times as fast as it was supposed to be. Oh, downloading. That's a good sign, huh?
I almost bought the game on my PlayStation because it was all half off for Christmas. I was like, man, I'm never gonna play it. I'm just gonna download a Stardom roster and never actually play the game. But the game's actually sort of fun, huh? The AEW game looks like it'll be something right up my alley. It's supposed to be a fucking predecessor to the old N64 THQ games that I grew up on.
Or you can just play those.
I can. Well, I put them in, and they hold up well enough.
It's probably...
But N64 games like are tough. They're like muddy.
I feel like there's a thing you gotta go to, edit mode, right? Workshop.
Oh, that sounds familiar. Like you had to put it into a faction or something.
Load, edit.
There it is.
No. Workshop. View workshop. Hanan.
Oh, that's bringing you right to where you are. That's funny.
Yeah, I have it.
I have it. I want to use it. Gotta put him in a team, damn it. New Age has gotta show you what to do.
Oh, gotta put them in a team edit?
So funny.
Apparently I've tried this before.
Well, yeah, yeah. Look at all that. You have a stars, you have everybody.
Oh, stars. What the transfer wrestler. What is happening? There's a million Great new team. Organization zero. I can name the team. I feel like this should be easier than it. I'm making it.
Oh, that's for sure.
Better, it's one of these things where you can just do anything, so it's like complicated.
It's a very sandboxy game from what I understand, which is what makes it great.
Team. Why? Transfer wrestler. Information. This is like turning into a whole operation here.
We have reached that.
How about I
point
Google
of the
it?
Night where I'm gonna have to leave you to your devices. It has been a pleasure podcasting and live streaming with you tonight.
Under create data. Yes, I'm not listening.
Konbanwa. Arigato gozaimasu.
Jare. Konbanwa.
Happy playing. Happy playing to you.
Click
until
add.
We meet again.
Model wrestler. Oh, this is annoying. Now I'm committed. Oh. Thank God for YouTube videos, huh? Let's see. Oh, maybe I need a guy. I don't even know who that guy is. Oh, this is not entertaining. I feel good at offline play. Well, there's always next time. if anyone's still around, thanks for hanging out. I'll definitely get this figured out because this is a lot of fun. I'm always bad at ending these things. Thanks, guys. I'm going to end the stream.